What's going on, everybody? It is Coach Greg Adams back in here with another YouTube live stream. Shout out to the Coach Gang.
And that's you.
For being in here, being involved, and being active on this YouTube channel. And welcome back to Monday Night Rawski. The longest running episodic program here on YouTube. You in here with the Bruce Wayne, it is Ish. The King of Kings, the King of Content, and the Speaker of Truth, yours truly. The Notorious One, a.k.a. New World Mr. Order. Culturalini, better known as the Prognosticator, Coach Adamus. And you're in the Desert Storm Bunker with none other than EWF. That is every woman's fantasy. And the whole effing show. The CEO, Niggero, of Fixes Binds LLC. The Unbinder, the Undebatable, the Undisputed Best Edutainment. Here on YouTube. You can call me Senor Gregorio Greybeard. The ladies love to call me Mr. Third Leg Greg.
Just phenomenal.
Also, I'm the man with no trabajo. I am the anointed one. The Morpheus of the mating matrix. The junior college sociologist. The chocolate of Confucius. The Black Moses. The deliverer. Also known as the man that walks in the spirit of Elijah. You in here with the man with more nicknames than anyone in the game. And the current King of Kings of this space and this content. And all of that in a bag of chips, ahoy. But if you forget all of that, just call me CGA and that is Saint God Allah. And I be the 10-time demonetized champion of YouTube. Coach Avelli in the building. In the building, Coach Avelli is back. Yes, indeed. Come with me. Hail Mary. Run quick, see. All right. But we got a great show for you lined up today. Just real briefly, Kevin Durant, NBA's Kevin Durant, he is an enigma. He should be considered one of the 5 to 10 greatest basketball players of all time. He's been accused of being a son husband. Also, many people might think he got some things going on in the background. I have no idea. A list has been attributed to young Kevin Durant. And he has a list of people that are... He has a list of people... That are, somebody's calling my phone. All right, he has a list of things that people might consider that men are staying single. All right, why men are staying single. And a lot of men, as you guys know, 60% of men, let me go ahead and show you this real quick. 60% of men are saying that they would rather stay single out here. Okay, let me go ahead and show you on the board. Most young men are single. Most young women are not. Now, you guys have seen slides like this. You've seen shows on this. 60% of men have no interest in relationships. Men are staying single. Women are not. And the majority of women in their certain age group, yep, as a matter of fact, they're looking to stay in relationships. They're dating older men. They're dating the top 10% men or the 20% of men. They're sharing men. And a majority of young men are saying, we have no issues here with staying single. Now, some people might attribute this to being lonely. All right, we're single and lonely. But for the most part, when you think about this, most of the reasons why men are staying single is there are no incentives. Most men believe that they don't have anything to offer women. But let's take a look at the list of why Kevin Durant says he's staying single. And I do have two sources here. We don't know if this is really him, but we're going to actually take a look at these, and I'm going to actually go through them, a few of them quickly. Kevin Durant says, I'm a massive overthinker, and he says he cares too deeply. I'm a be safe type of guy. Message me when you get home. Have a good night type of guy. And he also says, I have so much energy. And he says, I give my all to people who don't give half back. We're going to go to the rest of this list. But men are staying single. You're like, I don't have any time for this bullshit. Because they don't get anything back from women. Now, here's the thing, man. The 90s, they're not coming back, brothers. Listen.
Larry Bird's not walking through that door, fans.
The 90s ain't coming back.
Kevin McHale's not walking through that door. And Robert Parrish is not walking through that door.
Nah.
And if you expect them to walk through the door, they're going to be gray and all.
All right, so the 90s ain't coming back. So a lot of guys want a girl that's theirs, all theirs. They want a girl in their life. But that's not happening, especially when you're a guy like Kevin Durant. As you guys know, he don't brush his hair. All right, but he likes to play video games. He likes to chill. I don't think he's on no thug stuff. So he's not one of those guys. He did say he wanted to drink Scarlett Johansson's bathwater at one particular point. But you got to understand, Kevin Durant has essentially been isolated on an island developing his craft. He went to the University of Texas, played 1 year, and he jumped right into the NBA with the Seattle Supersonics. Eventually, they became the Oklahoma City Thunder. And he's been on an island focusing on his basketball and his craft and being blessed with millions and millions of dollars. As a result, he cannot find anyone genuine. But neither can you, all right? Neither can you. A lot of times the complaint about men is they cannot find anyone genuine. They can't even find a good girl. And sometimes they even say there's no incentive to be a good girl. So you're finding that more women are finding an incentive in their prime to deal with a certain type of guy to get the best out of their prime. All right. But we got to talk about this because we're going to read through this list. And if this list is really him, this might be some other guys. But as you can see, this list is what most men would actually like in a woman. Now, oddly enough, if you actually told some of those women to be a woman like this, they couldn't do it. In fact, if you tell a woman you're like, I love your femininity, a lot of women will be like, they'll simply ask you this. They're like,
what that mean?
All right, what do you mean when you say feminine? What do you mean when you say feminine? Okay. I once told a beautiful young woman, I was like, I like your femininity. But her software was so indoctrinated with feminist propaganda, she thought that was a slight at her. She first appreciated it. She was like, yeah, I am feminine. But what do you mean? What do you mean my femininity? I don't know exactly what you mean. Are you calling me subservient? Are you calling me weak? See, I don't want you to think I'm weak. I want you to think I'm strong. All right. I want you to think I'm strong. And you ever see a kid, you be like, make a muscle. And they be like, all right, they make a muscle. They be like, look at my muscle. They can't flex, right? They be like, ooh, look at my muscle. You be like, make a muscle. And the kid want to make a muscle. That's how kind of how women are. They want to be strong and brave. So femininity is kind of a slight at them. They're like, what do you mean by feminine? I'm strong. We're going to talk about that later on to today's show. Yes. So they want to be seen as strong and brave and stunning. 100%. But yeah, they want to know what you're talking about as to not take advantage of them because, you know, they don't trust you, although you want them. They want you to trust them. All right. But anyway, we got that coming up. What do we got coming up? We got Straggle and Sniggle Theater. We have Soft Guy Era. We're going to cover that today. And the struggle continues. We got a segment called The Struggle Continues. Anyway, to contribute to today's show, $ The Notorious CGA on the Cash App, Venmo, Coach Greg Adams TV, and PayPal is paypal.me/Coach Greg Adams. And that be pinned to the top of the live chat on the Free Agent Lifestyle channel. And yes, you can super chat Notorious CGA channel. All right, let's get to some earlier contributors to today's show. Be Real Mahogany says Durant is single because he kisses his mother on the mouth. No woman can compete. All right. No woman can compete. All right. Anyway, we got Mr. I Am Himothy Sports Betting. He says child support is 20% of your income. The finesse is divorce and child support. And he says it's 70% plus your income and assets. Send it, man. Listen. A lot of guys don't realize, you know, a lot of guys, money's one of the most important things to men. I mean, barring, you know, talking about spirituality, we understand that. But when we get into relationships, it's about the money. Some men want to get into relationships and they don't want to spend any money, right? That's kind of like the goal, right? For some reason, men measure how much they spend money, if a woman actually likes them or the money. That is the big conversation. It's kind of like with women, sex is the issue. Did you have sex? Did you give sex? What did you give when you gave sex? Are you doing wifely things and giving him sex? And what are you getting back, right? So money is important to the man. Sex is important to the woman. For men to understand that, yes, if you don't marry a woman, 20% of your income is going to go to her, and it's going to go in form of a payment directly to her. supposedly for your children, that is a turnoff. If you include the marital assets, it could be upwards to 70%. And people, when we say this, people go, well, wow, that's crazy. Well, really, yes. I mean, there have been cases where people don't understand the finances. This is why we're here. The finances in the divorce could be more than 50% of your assets that you have at the moment. Then when you dice up and add child support and potential division of assets and selling of properties and potential, all right, pension division, okay, if you have pension, retirement, maybe a 529 school, college fund, this could be well above 50% going into the 60, 70%. It is real. So a guy's main concern is that, and of course, men are starting to understand that. No man wants to give up 70% of their resources or what they save. No man wants to do that. But unfortunately, you know, that's important for us really to try to figure out, like, what do we do then? What do we do? You want to roll the dice? Most guys be like,
nope.
Shout out to Hodge says, women in my apartment hawked me down yesterday. She needed help moving a bed frame. I helped her because she was thick. She was the thick kind, the curvy type. And you might fix as a mind. Don't fix as a mind. No. Don't fix as a mind in your own apartment. Right? We always tell you, leave apartment broads alone. And I even had a nappy-headed mouthpiece ninja say, you could get girls in your apartment, and here we go again. And this ninja living in an apartment. There you go. I got girls in my apartment all the time. Just because you did it doesn't mean it's a good idea. Just because you could doesn't mean it's a good idea. All right? You guys love to play with these women. And when these women cut off your meat sausage, pause.
Hey, yo, chill, son. Hey, yo.
When they slash your tires, when they can easily find you and pop up like, merp. I don't know what guys are doing, man. Y'all playing with these women out here. Y'all playing with these women. All right. It's not a smart move. It's not a smart move. And there's other things that I talked about, but a ninja want to tell me, yeah. I do it all the time. All right, man, listen. Especially if I know I'm going to play around with this woman. If you're going to play around with her and having hoes and skeezers run up in your spot, nah, we not doing that. Loud Pocket says, I like flat backs more better. He liked them flat back Supremes. All right, shout out to him. And he also says, Coachy, I think you cut a video on the soft guy. I cut a video on the soft guy on the thumbnail. We call him Steph is Warm. All right, shout out to him. I'm going to make a video about him today. Steph is Warm. All right, shout out to Steph is Cold. Denaro Tranquillo says, thank you, Coach, for the daily education, helping us to deconstruct the lenses and the lens in which we are viewed today and how we view today's women. He says, while helping us to construct a better view of ourselves, free agent lifestyle for life. Shout out to you. And I did chop that up, but I got it. Okay. For the most part. I'm looking at it like, gosh, I mean, for me, a lot of guys end up in the simp category because that's all they have to leverage is simping. And you could be a rich man or a poor man. A lot of guys, they leverage simping. And it's going to be a long-term, a bad deal. Can you get the girl to give you some pity sex every now and then? Yes, but it's a bad deal. With that being said, let me get back to the shizzo and be down with the shizzits. And here it is right here, Straggle and Sniggle Theater.
Hey, ride with me if you ride with me. You can slide with me if you feel like 550 on the five sticky. Come get high with me. That's a deal, right?
Straggle and Sniggle Theater, man. The best show of them all. Straggle and Sniggle Theater, man. This, oh my goodness. Wait till you see this right here. Take a look at this right here. Okay, you got a big, I guess you would call it Peter Griffin looking ninja, and a flatback. Look at them flatbacks out there with the dress. All right, and check out your boy. He all up in there. He ready to put hands on hips. Let's go ahead and play the video without the music. Look at him. He getting jiggy. Oh my goodness. Oh, is that a Ling Ling? Oh. Oh no. Oh no. Y'all that just want to get married. I guess if my wife was doing that with some Chad, it would be crazy. Oh, no. He had Ling Ling cornered up. Look at him. He was ready to go. He was ready to go.
What kind of fuck you give me?
He was ready to risk it all. Look at this ninja. He's sniggling. Oh, no, 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 no.
Yeah, that brother's starving.
All right, his big old chunky fat wife grabbed that ninja back real quick. He was looking at some young, fresh and green. All right, yo, he was like, he could. Oh, no. Oh, my goodness, ninja. She said, not today. Look at this ninja. Stay. He's showing teeth and everything. Look at his fit. Look at his body, bro. Look at this fit, man. Yo, man, fix your. Oh, look at them cankles came and got him. Snatched that ninja right up with them big ass cankles. And oh my goodness, ninja. Wow. This kid can't have no fun.
Oh, the humanity.
Hey, he ain't seen it. This is what his wife looked like when he was married her the first time. Oh, not by the collar. Dang, man. Can I get me? Hey, man, let me dance with my little flatback Ling Ling. Let me get my Ling Ling. She said, hell no, ninja. Get your ass back over here, bruh.
Yeah, that brother's starving.
Yes, sir, brother.
You done forgot. You done forgot where you was, ninja, and you don't forgot who you was with. Snatched his ass. Damn, man. Ain't no respect. Speaking of respect, remember when I tell you this? What do I tell you? Women date in the gray areas. What happens is a woman you're dating, sometimes she's giving off weird vibes. You're dating her. You take her out on one date, two date, three date. You're looking to get a little bit of something on your finger. You're like, let me get a little something on my finger. And then just a little, you want to wet his little whistle. You want to wet your little whistle, right? But what do I tell you? There's another guy in the picture. So when you come into a woman's life, she might still be in a relationship. She still might be single seeing her ex. So she might be broken up, but the ex still gets access to her. And you don't realize this. So you're like, I want to put a little something on there. Let me get the head in. Let me put a little, and she'd be like, no. And then you're like, oh, what's going on, baby? Oh, you know, I don't want to rush. She says, let's wait a while. Before it's too late, let's wait a while. Before things go too far, ass bitch. And you trying to put a little, get a little stump on your finger. You know what I mean? And she acting up. Well, one of the reasons why is that she still gets access. The ex still gets access. So she's still trying to work it out. They still trying to get it a little bit wild. But her friends know, but yo goofy ass don't know. So you're on date number 3, 4, 5, 6, but her ex still beating them cheeks up. Let's go ahead and play the video.
Here she comes.
All right, there she go right there. All right, she got the clown music on. She calling her a clown. Oh, no. Yep, there it is right there, ninja. Hey. All right, there it is right there. She know, and she dropped that neck.
It's barbecue in there.
She dropped that neck. She dropped that neck. She embarrassed, and her tonsils got butter, and she split them legs open real quick. The ex put her down there, all right? The ex rearranged them guts, yep. Clown music. Even her friends are dissing her, but now when you come along, all right, you're the good guy. All right, you're such a good man, all right? But she said, hey, can you pick me up? Where are you at? I'm at my ex's house. Now, did you see the ex's house? It was literally a house. It was literally a house. Yep, she in there, walk of shame, leaking all over that woman's seat. Leaking all on that woman's seat, man. The ex still getting them cheeks. I hate him. I'm never going to be with him. She gets drunk texting the ex, goes over there super excited. Ex rearranges them guts and says, you got to go. And take a look at the house, guys. Look at the house. This is a nice house for the ex. And here's the thing, man. Yep, the ex is rich. Look at that house, bro. That's a ninja. That's a nice house. I don't care where you live. California, Florida. That's a nice ass house. Now, it could be even the ex-husband. But she walking out with them skinny legs, got folded up. You know why? Because when you're dating, when women start to date, it's hard to them to get sexual chemistry. It's hard to replace that. Now, every now and then, she will get her cheeks clapping, get a guy, but it's hard for her to replace that. It's better for her to go back to with somebody she's familiar with, all right, so she can get back that sexual thing, right? Women like sex, too. She can actually go back to her ex, and everything can line up. There's no pressure. She don't have to worry about condoms. She can get skeeted in her neck, right? She can. He knows how to choke her real good and tie her up. He know how to push her head into the pillow. He already knows what to do, as opposed to trying to get you, you know what I mean? Like, do this. Or, you know, women can't tell you to do this and do that. They got to kind of let you figure it out. Oh, I like that. Okay, yeah, I like when you choke me, daddy. All right, I like when you choke me, yeah.
Get him, daddy.
But the ex already know how to choke her, right? You know what I mean? So she went back, and the man got some money, too. The man got some money.
I got money.
She probably was in a bind, too. She probably was in a bind. That's why she over there as well. All right, Drag One's Nickel Theater, man. What's going on with this? This is a funny meme by Domonique. Chef Domonique. Domonique. It says, this lady at work told me she left her first husband because he didn't pay 100% of the bills. And then she says, he wanted a 70-30 split. That's fair. Now she's working two jobs, all right? I guess you won't settle for less. Oh, no. Ninja, give her the bill. Yes, man. Guys, I find it funny when women make this decision. All right, he ain't going to do this and he ain't going to do that. And then they become single and they end up doing all those things. Like, I don't want to cook or clean. Like, bitch, like, that's what you're going to cook and clean for yourself when you leave here. All right. I would need a man that paid 100% of my bills and then they stay single for 10 years. And you be having to get a second job. One of the things we tell men, guys, always call their bluffs. Always call their bluff. Chef Domonique says right there, bruh, she left her husband because he didn't want to pay the bills. Now she got to work two jobs to make ends meet. Oh, my goodness, man. I tell you. You know what I mean? It happens. And now she's struggling. All right, where we at here? We got a woman that says, if you get into, I was just talking about this. I don't get it with you new people here. It says, woman says she will end any relationship if the man refuses to share his location. Quote, it's only one reason why a man won't share his location. Now, I'm going to tell you this. Sharing a location is whack. Fucking whack, bro. Like, I don't get that, bro. I would never do no crazy shit like that. All right, but let's hear what she has to say.
If we married and my husband refuses to share his location with me, yes, I have heard of this scenario before. We get a divorce. Matter of fact, we would have spoken about this already during our dating stage. And if I find out you don't believe in sharing your location with your wife, we ain't gonna make it no further anyway. Because I know what it means. There's only one reason a person don't want to share their location with you that you're romantically involved with, supposed to be in a relationship with, and that's because they don't want you to know where they're at. There's only one reason a person don't want you to know where they're at, because they know you wouldn't like where they're at, right? That's simple. Okay. So, no, that's what cheating looks like. Cheating don't look like you walking in on a man in bed with a woman. We don't all get the benefit of seeing it for a fact like that. And yes, I call it a benefit. If you're getting cheated on, you may as well know you're getting cheated on. So yeah, it's a benefit for it to be given to you in such a sure package. We don't get that benefit. You got to look at the signs. You got to stop ignoring your gut. You got to use your intuition. You got to use your mind and your common sense. That's what cheating looks like. Cheating looks like, you know, he hide his phone. He always falling asleep.
Yeah, man, that's going to be a no for me, man. Listen, she got some more to say.
Always falling asleep over his boy house drunk, and nobody had a charger. As far as I know, ain't but two cell phone chargers in the world.
I think women normally pull this trick, but I get it. I get what she's saying, especially in situations like that, right? You know, I fell asleep over there at my boy's house. Okay, I get what you're saying there, but sharing location in a normal relationship, I think that's weird. I think that's weird, but y'all can do whatever y'all need to do, bro.
Somebody had that lightning or that USB-C or whatever it is for Androids. Somebody somewhere had one. You could have drove to the gas station and got one. Like, no.
Nah, she too insecure for me, man.
That's what cheating looks like. Oh, he dropped his phone in the toilet. Oh, he had a tire blow out on the highway. How many times you let your man have his tire blow out on the highway? That's what cheating looks like. Wake up. Pay attention.
Yeah, I mean, she's not wrong. What in the hell is that? All right, she's not wrong about being cautious about hearing these stories, right? And I agree. These stories are ridiculous. Oh, I didn't have my phone and my battery dead and I didn't have a charger. Yeah, these stories are quite ridiculous. But sharing the location is a no-go. All right, that's a no-go. I don't know. You new ninjas, man. I'm going to tell you. You new people, you guys are different. You guys are built differently. But technology allows you to believe you should be able to do this. I'm definitely not with that. I'm not with that bullshit. All right, we have a brother here, Glocktavius. All right, Glocktavius, is that you?
And that's you.
All right, look at Glocktavius. All right, he has two businesses right here. And he's this is one of these balloon shows. And women are going to decide whether Glocktavious is the guy for them. All right, so let's go ahead and play it.
I have two businesses that I own. I have a solutions business and also own a cleaning service, which I property manage for.
Did get a few balloons popped. Let's go over to these ladies, see what's going on there.
Mainly because of the height.
Well, trees get chopped down every day.
Okay. Just height. That's all.
All right. Somebody, man almighty. Okay, the music in this video here. I always forget it's music. All right, so we got straggle daggles right here. We definitely got straggle daggles. All these girls are daggles for sure. All right, one doesn't look like much of a daggle, but we got a whole bunch of daggles here. So height is throwing them off. She has two businesses, and we got height. All right, let's continue here.
Oh, let's go back over here.
All right, so I get the height one for this one too?
And why did you end up popping your balloon?
Your skinny jeans. You're a very handsome man. I just wish like you would have got the beard a little lined up.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so we got height, the beard lined up. We got, what did she say? Skinny jeans. Okay, his swag was whack. I mean, these are some of the things that men are facing out here. And of course, they're getting rejected by pure daggles and skeezers. But that's neither here nor there. You guys got to not put your ego with these people. They fickle. All right. You think you can, you know, he can change his beard up. These are all changeable things. What was the other thing? Skinny jeans. All right, boy, that's, I swear to God. What else?
Really, yeah. Everything else, like the height doesn't bother me. Your outfit, you look fly.
She has a pretty face. Right,
he looked fresh. She has a pretty face.
If you ask me.
Oh, no.
Damn, I can't like somebody with a pretty face. I have two businesses.
All right, man. Damn, Glocktavious got reamed, ninja. Damn. All right. So, but they would have probably let him hit it if he ran game on him. They probably would have let him hit it if he ran game. But he didn't run no game, so he can't get into a serious relationship. Damn, ninja. That man, I'll tell you, man. One of the things about the dating landscape, just as a general thing, that guys are just getting... Guys got it all fucked up from the rip. I mean, that's how it's always been like that, but it's on a little bit of a hypersteroid. So guys are like, shit, if he getting shot down by them ugly straggle daggles, it's wild. All right, what is this next one here? Is this the next? I guess that's the next segment. So that's Straggle and Sniggle Theater.
Hey. With me if you ride with me, you can slide with me if you feel like 550 on the fast sticky, come get high with me, that's a deal, right?
All right, man, Straggle and Sniggle Theater. Hit the like button. Just give me the likes. Don't pass the scroll. Mulla, 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 mulla. All right, we got that going on here. Don't hit. And that one, don't kick my flow. All right, I don't even know the song lyrics, but shout out to Desert Brew Crew. Says shout out to my favorite truth teller and Juco Slayer. Taxes and insurance sucks, but he says it sure is worth it. By the way, my wife always laugh when you say punani. Shout out to your wife. She likes that. She was like, I like when him say punani. I like that. All right. They like it. They like that attention. All right. What are we doing here? Shout out to Ninja Snuggle Coach. I heard your rant earlier about men not supporting women no more. And there's no benefit. There's no benefit be women anymore. I'm not sure what that says. But he says, I just want to say I would support a woman, but I don't want to lose my kids again. Right. Yeah. I mean, listen. I understand that, man. You know, women are a complete gamble, especially when you have babies with them. Fresh is figuring that out now, and we've been trying to tell guys. But look, normally it doesn't happen that early. You know what I mean? Normally it's, you know, after a few years, you know, maybe 2, 5, 7. You got to wait for that postpartum depression to get in there. But when a guy gets traumatized like that, where he loses his kids, I almost am certain that he'll rarely ever get back into the game like that. You lose your kids. Like, your kids are, like, that's your DNA. That's your responsibility. That's who you're supposed to protect. And then what'll happen is this woman will take your kids and just be like, fuck you, and you can't see your kids. Oh, yeah. You definitely ain't going back in. Now, instead of telling men to go back in, perhaps, and this is definitely for women, women who would be like, well, just, I will never do that. That woman's evil, right? Well, she's capable of doing this. She's fully capable of doing this, the new woman, but she wants to risk it for the biscuit. She'll take the risk. I think it's insane when you've done that. And also, 50 Cent did the same thing, and look at him. Now he potentially might have another issue with another baby mama. Oh, man, it's crazy. All right, what do we got here? Let's see here. Where am I at? I understand it. Shout out to the resurrected simp enforcer. CGA, I have 50-50 custody, and my baby mama terrorist is trying to move my kids out of state. There you go, guys. With a pookie because she was accepted for Section 8. Isn't this against the law? Any advice? There you go, guys. This is what guys have to look forward to. If you have kids and you're melanated, highly likely you're going to be not alienated. You're going to be separated from the child's household. All right. So we're talking about 70-80% chance you have kids and you're melanated. You're going to be on a custody agreement. Highly likely. Very rare that you raise those kids from 0 to 17. Now, let's get back to this one. Okay, if you're not melanated, it's a 50-50. It's a coin flip. If you're a white American and a Latino family, 60% chance. It's almost certain. Now, what's going on here? She found a simp. Well, she found a cleanup man.
And that's you.
And then she's going to get Section 8. So why does she have a man but then Section 8? That's a red flag. My best advice is I would be preemptive. I would go file first. If you can afford it, I will go file before the move. If she does move, I will file an emergency petition to try to get it overturned. And at this particular point, good luck, because the judge can deny it. And essentially what you're going to do is you're going to create a longer case. The case could take 8 months or so, unless the judge is hypervigilant about getting those kids back. If the woman has already left, it's going to be hard for the judge to get that woman back unless the judge threatens the woman with jail time. Move the kids back. But judge might say, well, the kids are moved, we'll figure it out, and now you got a legal battle. But I would go file first, especially if they are moving, they got a moving truck. I would go file and say she did not give me enough warning to move the kids, and she's causing an issue. All right, so there you go right there, man. How old are the kids? That might have something to do with it as well. If these kids are under adolescence, then yes, it might be definitely worth the fight. If they're over adolescence, might want to let that shit go. I mean, because you're gonna dump tens of thousands of dollars into that custody battle. But it's just about what you want to do. Because if you don't fight, people are going to say, you should have fought for your kids. You should have fought. If you do fight, you're putting your kids through trauma. Your kids can't handle moving to a new area. You're traumatizing them. They're going to blame you. So be ready for this shit. But it is what it is. But yeah, if she hasn't moved, I would go file and say, judge, this woman is attempting to move my kids. And file it as an emergency petition, an ex parte. This is not legal advice. This is still entertainment advice. But I will file an emergency petition. I will drag her into court the next day. So if you go down to the courthouse, you can go down there on a Tuesday. You can have her in court by Wednesday. And then you would have to have her tell it to the judge. All right? And they might put a kibosh to that shit. Now, if she comes in there, she's normally probably going to come in here with some allegations and some accusations. Namely, you're abusive to the kids or abusive to her. So be prepared for that. Shout out to Deshaun Rose says, will she share her location too? The answer is
nope.
She better share her location if I got to share mine. He says, what does the joint custody agreement state? Well, it probably states that you need to give advance warning before you move. And that's basically almost every generic custody issue. You got to give advance warning. So if it says that, she has to give you advance warning. And normally advance warning means she has to notify the court. So she can't just notify you. She has to notify the court. More than likely, that's what it says. And then if she has to notify the court so you guys can have a time to rehab these issues, then maybe you will get her to prevent the move. And but just be ready, man. These courts move like molasses. They move like sloths. Courts move very slowly. All right. They don't move quickly. And Maryland guy says, hey, coach, I used to look at attractive women like they were some kind of deity until I went to kiss one and her breath stank. He says, I never looked at them the same afterwards. Yes. Yes, it's interesting, right? I always tell guys, man, get you some attractive women as early as you can, ninja. Be around them. But if you a simp, ninja, please don't do this. You're going to get sprung. But I've been telling you, man, attractive women are human beings, guys. They're human beings. They poop. They fart. They drop deuces in the toilet. They'll try to not let you see or hear any of that, though. But, guys, they just regular human beings like you. And they're super insecure. And sometimes they breath stink. Sometimes they got bad pH balance. Sometimes they got good pH balance. Sometimes they feet stink. You don't never know what you're going to get. So you want to kind of get over. You want to get over pretty women. I think pretty women are somewhat of a commodity. Yes, they can leverage that. But you want to get over them. Get over it. All right, here you go right there. They're just human beings, man. And they're somehow, some way, kind of subpar human beings. And I don't say that to slight them. It's just interesting. You know what I mean? Like, I always say, they're a human being that is kind of, well, Chronicles of Judah said they're children with breasts. And that is the best way to describe them. They're adult children with breasts. And we're going to go through this in the next segment. And the reason why I say that is that they're an adult-sized person, but they still need help. You know what I mean? They're still kind of like incapable. And this is very general. There are some outlier women. Go, you go, girl. But they're still kind of incapable of helping themselves. And they still like need you. So you still got to kind of, they still got to get through life like with you or all of that stuff. And they're like, I don't need no guy. All right, just wait. So they're kind of like an incapable human being, like an adult, a large child. But their brain, imagine, I'll say it like this. It's kind of like when black people were segregated, but you were like, yeah, but we can be in your society. They wanted to cross over so bad, and white folks was like, nah, you can't be over here. And we're like, but we can do it, right? All kind of shit. Then you went over there, and you were like, it's the same over here. So when you're having these restrictions, other people are restricting y'all. Now, dear. All right, just sit down over there. But they have like an adult brain. Their brain is adult. Their size is somewhat of a full-size adult. Some are larger than a full-size adult. But at the same time, they're limited. You know what I mean? Like, they got limitations. They got limitations that 80% of men don't have. Like, that can mess your brain up. You know what I mean? You'll just be like, damn. So it kind of sucks for them. You know what I mean? Like, you got to feel, well, I don't feel shit for them, but you got to kind of understand where they're coming from. And their whole life is like, I can prove it. I can do it. I don't need you. I don't need a man. They kind of get to the point where they're like, I can show you I don't need a man until they need a man.
Nope.
They gonna need one. Now, dear. Pipe down. All right, silly broad. He said this silly dame. All right, ladies, enough of the games. Everybody sit down. I said be quiet. It's kind of like a dog. You know what I mean? It's like a dog when it goes out, the dog's big and tough. But when it poops, it's all looking at you like, I'm pooping. Watch my back. You know what I mean? And you looking at the dog looking at you with that weird ass. You're like, damn. The dog looking at you taking a shit like, all right, I can't defend myself now. I'm taking the shit. So they're all tough and big until they need help. And they're looking at you, help. And you're like looking at them like, I thought you were big and bad. All right, shout out to the ladies, man. You got to help them out. You got to know that's their plight. They just want to prove that they can just be, I can prove I can do it. I did it. I really did it myself. You just be like,
silence, you fool.
Yeah. Where we at here? That's kind of them. That's them in a nutshell. So you kind of want to measure that up. That's why I don't know why guys are intimidated by them or really just said they don't. Why do they piss you off? They really don't do nothing. They all bark, no bite. Yeah, they all bark, no bite. They can't do nothing. Now, if you penetrate them, if you sexually assault them, if you do anything sex with them, you just gave them the leverage, just so you know. If you have sex with them, now you done gave them the leverage. And I'm talking about free sex. You gave them leverage, or you skeet in them, or they are pregnant, or you marry them. You just handed all that leverage. Now you can't be like, now, dear. Now, young lady, have a seat. I said quiet.
Silence, you fool.
Shout out to Dion says, 41, I got time to get my money up so I can be and have a 21-year-old at 65. Plenty of time. Plenty of time. Plenty of time, man. Hey, the thing is, always, look, when we talk about younger women and older women, younger women and older women, and they'd be like, them young girls don't want you. You can't get a hottie. All right, you'll be old and gray with hairy gray balls. All right, guys, the way this works is men can get a woman like that. It only takes one. And there's 4 billion there's 4 billion women on the planet, metaphorically. It only takes one 21-year-old woman to go. You don't need 8 21-year-old women. You don't need thousands of them chasing you. In fact, most men don't have but two or three women interested in them at one time. And that's higher-tier men. Higher-tier men only have a few women interested at one time. You don't need every 21-year-old woman to be looking at you. You just need one. And yes, she going. She going. The reason why she goes is this one reason. And this is the only reason. Men do not sell attraction. We don't sell looks. That's not our number one sale. So women don't ever understand that. So they'll just be like, but you're old and you're bald and you're hairy and you're, you got hairy back. That shit don't mean nothing when it comes to men. For a woman that has a hairy back, old, bald, and soggy, that means everything. Because women advertise and sell beauty. They sell youth, vitality, energy, and fertility. They sell health and all that. That is the number one thing when you're looking for a woman. That's number one. For men, it could be top priority for a woman, but it's something she can overlook. Eh, I don't need all that handsome guy shit. Does he have stability? Does he have humor? Is he kind? All right, all these matter. Does he safety and security? Like, all right. You don't need to lead with looks. Men don't need to lead with looks. Looks are an extra benefit. It's a cherry on top. It's a cherry on top. And he's somewhat handsome. Oh, I think I can get over that. Ninja, half the time she with you, her eyes are closed. She don't give a fuck. She just like, get this over with. And by the way, every year, women turn 21. So, Loud Pocket says, I like the flatbacks more better. I already got that. That means I can get on with the next show. The struggle continues. We have some ladies here adapting to adulthood, and they struggling with it. All right, so let me see what they got talking about here. It says, the struggle saga continues. Maybe this, okay, here it is right there. Yes. All right, so we have a woman you see right there. She says, where did the men go?
What happened? Where did all the men go?
Man, I feel like I still have another 5 to 10 year run here. Thanks to Gen Z, you guys are now entering into the years that when I first started this content along the way and was watching this content, we were going through the same thing y'all went through. So you guys got another 10 years of frustration, and then Gen Alpha is going to follow you. This shit is just going to keep going around in circles at this point. So now we have another, that's you.
And that's you.
What happened? Where did all the men go?
What happened? Where did all the men go?
Here we go. All right. This is the 25 to 28 to 30 asking where the men went.
Girlies in their late 20s, early 30s.
Late 20s, early 30s.
And that's you.
We're stuck in this vacuum, guys. Thank God I started trying to do this job. All right. This shit going to go on forever. Right? All right. For the girls, late 20s and early 30s, let me guess, you participated in hookup culture?
Is anybody else just over this hookup culture?
All right, let's see what she got here.
Where are we finding men?
Unfortunately, they are working overtime instead of going out and dating because they feel they will never be attractive enough or wealthy enough for a girl ever again. They would rather check their weather app than chat with another person on Hinge. If they're not at work, they're usually at home, the gym, playing video games with friends, or fighting for democracy. You're welcome.
Single girlies in their late 20s, early 30s. Where are we finding men?
She was like, where are we finding men? Like, where are we finding men? Like, where are we finding men? Open your eyes. Like, guys, when you go outside, are you like, there's no women out here? Right? Like, we go outside and we see women everywhere. We're like, wow, I'll take her. I'll take that one. I'll take her. I'll bend her over. I'll clap her cheeks. I'll marry her. I'll date her. I'll simp for her. Ninja, we see him everywhere. I'll even clap her. Look at granny in them soggy titties. I'll clap her on a Tuesday. Even the fat girl, I'll take her. I'll take her. Ninja walk outside starving.
Yeah, that brother's starving. Yes,
sir, brother. Where are we finding men? I just can't find them. I'm out all the time with my nose in my phone at Starbucks. Where are all the men at? Where are we finding men? Where are all the good ones at? Yeah, we just want the good ones. All right, the top guys. Yes. Other than that, all the rest of them could go. Where are we finding men? And this woman said what Kevin Durant is saying. Man, we got other shit to do. Dealing with you bird brains. Dealing with these bird brains. I actually had a clip like this on my Instagram. Let me see if I can pull it up real quick. Oh, wait a minute. That's YouTube. Instagram. I think it was on my Porsche channel, but let's see here. Oh, here it is right here. Here it is right here. Listen to this woman. She says,
men with no hoes, where are you? What are you doing?
She said, men with no hoes, where are you? Where are you? Where are the guys that don't have no hoes? Like, a lot of guys be like, we can't get no women. And she's like, where are you guys at?
What happened? Where did all the men go?
Isn't this crazy? I mean, this is sad to see in our society that it's coming down to this for a lot of people. You know, unfortunately, we have another woman here. It says, maybe this is why millennial and Zoomer women are floundering. All right, here we go.
You know why I'm never going to shut up about being a single girl who lives alone is because I am the first woman, not only in my family, in my entire lineage, who's able to live alone. My mom was never able to live alone. Her mom was never able to live alone. Her mom was never able to live alone. Multiply that times infinity for the rest of forever till the beginning of humanity. And it actually is that deep. If you're a girly who's living right now in your own little apartment, can afford your own bills, can pay your own rent, you don't rely on your family, you don't rely on a man in your life to financially provide for you, you're quite literally breaking generational trauma. I can literally say it started with me. My sisters, everyone after me, I was the first. I was literally the first woman in my entire female lineage to live alone. It is that deep, and that's fucking crazy, and I will not shut up about it.
Oh, my goodness, man. Look.
Silence, you fool.
All right. We're the first ones.
And shut up.
I got a question. How's that working out for you? How's that working out? Just be honest. How's that working out for you? Is this working out for you? You have your little box apartment. We all got to start it. We already got to start somewhere. How's that working out? See, this is what's happening. They're like, we can do this and I can do it. And I'm big and bad. I don't need no guy. Yes, I'm an adult. Yeah, that's what you fought for equality for. And that's what men step to the side for. Okay, we have to step to the side. You're equal. You can have your own place to live. Now, when you start dating, don't start asking for rent.
Your rent's due.
Because, yes, you're going to start asking for rent after a couple of months. She's happy. Congratulations to her. For moving into her first apartment when her mother could not, when her sister could not. She going to be selling booty cheeks at some particular point to pay that rent. She's going to want a man to move in here. She's also going to call the maintenance guy. And then when the maintenance guy comes while she's in the shower with a towel on, barely coming out of the shower with her feet out, like, oh, big bad maintenance guy. Oh, what are you doing here? He's like, what are you doing here? All right, and then she gonna want a man. Oh, my maintenance guys, extra creepy. It's gonna happen, guys. Give it some time. All right, what do we got here on TikTok? TikTok. What do we got here? This young woman here has sis. Okay, what's going on here? Let's go ahead and roll it back here. Let's play the video.
I'm quite literally rolling around in horse shit, trying to get this bottom thing off my car. I don't want to talk about it. I'm gonna cry. I'm trying to get this off, and I need a screwdriver.
Oh no!
I just wish someone would pull over and help me.
Oh no! Oh
the humanity!
Oh no, Ninja! Hey man, it was independent until your car broke down. You know, so you had to get something fixed. Now you need a man. And she got her lungs all pressed against the floor. And you recorded this video. Like, what is the thing with them going right to recording? I mean, I get it. You got 1.3 million likes on this video. So this is in a 10 million view. And you know, simps and these little titties out here, she got pressed against the floor. They want to go help her. Oh, this is called the damsel in distress. Now, what are you doing here? I told you about getting a toolbox. It was all gravy until your car broke down, until your car doesn't start. Now you need a man. And why you got scissors out? You just going to cut it out? You're just going to cut it. You might need a car lift for that one. You might need to lift this car. All right. Or you're going to need a man to crawl up under there. And, of course, it's time to get dirty and dangerous, and she don't want to do it. All right. What is going on here?
Oh, someone just pulled over. No way.
Thank you so much.
Dog.
All right. So, look, the SA came and saved her. All right. So, the SA came to save her. She definitely in Arizona. All right, she's definitely in Arizona. This looked like an Arizona Latina. And so the essay came over to save the day. Go ahead, Ninja. Give it to her. Give it to her. I hope you got the... And, of course, if this was anybody's daughter, they would love something for like this to happen. They go to essay right there. He got the L.A. tattoo. Maybe. Oh, it's California. It's California. They even put her license plate in there. Don't be a creep and look her up. So the essay came and saved her. Let's see what it looks like under there. All right, he got tools. Yep, he got some tools. And I can't tell what it is. It might be the pan gasket. Looks like it dropped and it's dragging, potentially causing some issue here. But boy, was she distraught. Let me see what we got here. I can't really tell. That's just a covering that looks like it came apart. And it probably was like that for a long time. Now she got the scissors. Jesus. All right. She got the scissors out. I don't think the scissors is going to do it, baby. You can't just cut that out. That's going to cause some whole bunch of other issues. And I'm pretty sure it was like that for a few weeks and you ignored it. Man, boy, she was in a pickle here.
I'm quite literally rolling around in horse shit, trying to get this bottom thing off my car.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, yeah. See, this is the children with breasts. I mean, this is literally children with breasts. And she's a young woman, too. But that's it's the plastic guard, the skid plate, splash plate.
Something off my car. I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, man. Oh, no. Man, this is not good right here. Just.
Oh, the humanity.
Yeah. This ain't it, man. That strong and independent shit only go for too far, man. I don't think cutting it off is going to be the trick, though. And look at her. She's like, I'm going to just cut it off.
Shit. Trying to get this bottom thing off my car. I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to cry. I'm trying to get this off.
Oh, Ninja, it broke down fast. It broke down fast, bruh. You know, I always know, man, with women, it breaks down hella fast. Like, they turn into children really quickly. All right, but they try. They be like, I'm really doing it. And then life hits them. They're like, oh, I'm not really doing it no more. All right, what do we got here? We have a... Dude, why do people do this? This is a woman who posted this and said, a DEI female pilot moment. This is insane. Now, remember, this is a woman posting this right there. All right, okay, so she's a... looks like a conservative woman. And she says, you know, these airlines are trying to get more female pilots. And they're like, hooray, we're getting more pilots. They're trying to get more black women to fly. All right. And all of this stuff. And they're like, all right, yes, hooray. Because I think 1% of all pilots are black women. Okay. And women in general are under 10% of all represented pilots. So there goes Rosie the Riveter. But this female pilot decided to do this.
Okay, if you don't feel safe, get off the airplane.
But this is your captain speaking, okay. But never like this.
I'll stop, and we'll fly the airplane. Don't worry, I'm going to let my co-pilot fly it. He's a man. Okay?
It's a total meltdown. The pilot boarded in her street clothes and addressed the passengers over the intercom. Passenger Pam O'Neill couldn't believe what was happening.
She said, let's take a vote. How many of you would like to take off now with me dressed as I am? Or would you prefer that I take 10 minutes to get changed into my cute old uniform? She started talking about her divorce and political candidates. And the minute she mentioned that, a gentleman stood up and just yelled, whoa. Enough, you're scaring me.
Another passenger, Randy Reese, got up to leave and gave a running commentary on social media.
Oh, no.
Also insulted a couple on board.
Did I offend you? Okay, so did I purposely offend you? I did. The answer is yes. Flight attendants, please disarm doors.
After 20 passengers insisted on getting off the United Airlines flight, the pilot quietly left the aircraft.
Okay, if you don't feel safe, get off the airplane.
Wow, man, what is going on with these ladies out here?
Silence, you fool.
What? That is crazy. That is crazy. Is this a skit? Is this a skit? So imagine, I would have got off the plane. So she had a meltdown. She probably was drunk. All right, what happened to the co-pilot? Why didn't it be like, what are you doing, man? Give me the intercom. But you probably couldn't do that because she would have been like, DEI, harassment. She's having a meltdown. Of course, she's a divorcee. Kaylee Cerna Karen. All right. So her Sogmeister going to hit her here. All right. She's 40 and fabulous. She's a pilot. I'll go fly in my street clothes. She literally was like, would y'all mind if I fly in my street clothes? This cannot be real. This is unbelievable, ladies. Wow, I hope she was fired for this. Yep, them head meds was not head medding. This is why I always say, man, I want to see that woman pilot. I'm looking at her like, oh, no. Because she could be zooted. Man, just get your butt, man. Stop. Man, that's insane, bro. They be having some female privilege like a mother sucker, man. That's some privilege. All right, what do we got here? A couple of other young women here struggling. And then we got soft guy era coming up. We have this woman that says how she gets out of a bind. We got a Latina. All right, we got a Latina woman here that says she takes on side gigs because she doesn't need a man. Now, her side gigs are very interesting. Let's see what her side gig. Look at the big-eyed woman. Look at this big-eyed little muskrat. All right, what does he say here?
And one of them was smuggling tortillas across the Mexican border.
What the
paid $2,000 after
what?
After gas because you need a permit and the restaurant that was doing it. Took on side gigs, and one of them was smuggling.
Yeah, man. Tortillas.
Tortillas across the Mexican.
I
want
to say it. Tortillas. Tortillas. All right. Tortillas. All right. Tortillas. You mean tortillas? Like tortilla chips? Like Tostitos? Or Tostitos? She's talking regular, and she wants to get that tortilla in it. You know what I mean? Just say the regular English way. Ninja, you already talking regular English. Don't be trying to tortillas. But she's smuggling tortillas. All right, there's nothing wrong with it. Merp. Merp. All right, what do we got here? We got another one. Okay, Millie Mouth Muskrat here. She says, couldn't pay me this amount to do this. All right, so we got another side hustle. Women are out here trying to get through, bruh. Women are out here trying to get it through. Here we go.
This is the sketchiest thing I'm doing to make extra money. I've started selling trade lines on my credit cards.
I'm using this site. This isn't sponsored. I just want to point out that they're like legit. And so essentially what this is, if a person has bad credit, but they know that they need to get a mortgage or a car loan or something, they pay money to this website. This website matches them up with me based on what they're looking for. And I add them as an authorized user to my credit card for a set amount of time. They don't physically get any sort of card. They don't get my name. They don't have my information. I have all of their information. But the thing is, because they're an authorized user, they get my credit history, and that raises their credit score. They get a better interest rate on whatever loan they're trying to get. And I would not be doing this if I didn't know multiple people in person who had also done this and like said it was legit, because it seems so sketchy. I gave this website my banking information so that they can direct deposit me money. And the amount you get paid depends on your credit limit, the length a card has been open, various things. And so the ones I have ranges from $40 to $80. Which might not sound like much, but if I get $40 and it took me 5 minutes to add an authorized user on my credit card, that's worth it for me. So I've done this a few times now. I think I have 8 possible spots on my different credit cards. They've paid out about $200 so far, and I have another $200 pending. I don't know if I would recommend it from the other side, because these people are giving me their full name, birth date, address, and social security number. Like, they just have to trust that I'm not gonna sell that on the black market. I don't even know how to do that. So their secret's safe with me, but I don't think they're getting any of my information. Anyways, if you have a good credit score, this may be for you.
Well, she got a lot of forehead. I will put something on that forehead, too. I mean, her hairline is pushed back. But that's what happens when you have thin hair. Guys, be careful with these things, man. I mean, how about a job? No. So now you get this is these are the side hustles. We got tortillas. We got tortillas, $200 across the border. And we got credit card finesser. We got this. This right here. This is how they getting through. And also, they in a bind, too.
Your rent's due, motherfucker.
All right. We also have this, too. All right. We also have them Fixes Binds. All right. Fixes Binds LLC. All right. Is a thing. People saying it's legit. It don't. It sounds. It could be legit, but hell no, bro. Come on, man. I don't even know, man. Like, why are we doing all this, man? You just couldn't get. Can't get a husband. This how you're going to do it. You're going to do this scam. How long are you going to do this? How long are you going to do it? We got the tortillas and the Milky Muskrat right here. The Milky Muskrat. Doing side hustles, scamming the credit card company. Man, this is crazy. All right, man. Look, man, y'all got to be careful out here, man. It's an evil world out here. All right, let me see here. We got another one. We got another one. Here we go right here. I'm a first-generation HBCU graduate. I'm now broke and lonelier than ever without my college friends for support.
Let you get it through your thick skull that I'm broke.
Yeah.
Dead, flat, stony, broke. I've got $3.85 in my purse.
Yeah. You know, colleges, what about your friends? And she the thick time, too. She graduated HBCU, by the way, for the white people. That's a historically black college and university. She graduated from Spelman College. Did you guys know most of these institutions are named after white people? Yeah, y'all didn't know that, did y'all? I'm pretty sure somebody told y'all that. Spelman was a white person. I believe she was connected to Spelman was the wife of the Rockefeller. Rockefellers? Did you guys know that? I think who was Spelman the wife of? Grambling was a white landowner that donated the land to the college. Grambling. Yeah, Grambling's not a black name. It was named after a white man named Grambling. Right. And he owned the land that the new college sits on. They named it Grambling. All right. Let me see here. A lot of people don't know this, but I have useless information like this. Yeah. Howard too. Clark. These are all white people. So, yeah, Spellman was the wife of, let me see here. Spellman is the wife of Rockefeller. Yeah, John Rockefeller. As you guys know, we always tell you, it says right here, yeah, John D. Rockefeller's wife is Lauren Spellman. That's her middle name. Laura Spellman. That was her maiden name. Her maiden name is Spellman. All right, so there it is right there, the Black College. So right there, Laura Spellman is this woman, this white woman who was the wife of John D. Rockefeller, who was one of the major people who donated the money for you Negroes to go to college. All right, and Grambling as well. This is just, why do I have this information, bro? Grambling University, Grambling named after, let me see here. All right, hold on for a second. What the hell? Named after. Grambling University is named after P.G. Grambling. 1946, the school became Grambling College, named after P.G. Grambling, the white sawmill owner who had donated the parcel of land where the school was constructed. All right, if you will.
I'm not going to say what race, what people. We know I can't say that.
Yeah, I mean, I love history. Dude, this is all history shit to me, man. I love it. Who was Howard University named after? People who went to school know this stuff. Let's see here. I love messing with Negroes. You know what I mean? Howard University, Major General Howard right here. Howard University is named after Major General Oliver Otis Howard. And there he is right there. Right there he is right there. Oh, ninja. God dang. Oh,
I'm not going to say what race, what people. We know I can't say that.
Yeah, there he is right there. General Howard. I love it, man. Sooner or later. There's a couple of universities that are like this is too, man. I tell you. All right. But anyway. All right. Anyway, Hampton University as well, man. I love it. Love it, man. You got to love it, right? That's our history. That's our history. Hampton, you know, but when we tell you that the public school indoctrination is funded by the Rockefeller Institute, you guys don't know. Here it is. Hampton University founded by Samuel Chapman Armstrong. That definitely looked like a white guy right there. All right. Anyway, the Boulé.
New world order.
Yep. There's a white dude right there. Samuel C. Armstrong. How did he name Hampton University? He's known as Hampton University right there. Okay. All right. That's the founder right there. There's the founder right there. Oh, ninja. God dang, ninja. I just tell you. Drug history with CGA. All right. Why do I tell you stuff like this? I have no idea. All right. These are the HBCUs. Clark in Atlanta was the same thing. Y'all Negroes or something else. Clark University. Let's see who Clark. Jonas Gilman Clark.
I'm not going to say what race, what people. We know I can't say
there
that.
It is. Jonas Gilman Clark. The Clark story, 1887. Jonas Gilman Clark founded Clark University as his first all graduate school. Okay, is that the same one? Yeah, man. Gilman? Yeah, that's definitely a Kanye West connection right there. Anyway. Yeah, man. If you think about it, yep, W.E.B. Du Bois. Telling you, man, it's crazy. But anyway, shout out to y'all brothers out there. Here, the struggle continues. So this woman says here she graduated HBCU Spellman. At the school, I met inspiring Black women who became my community. Now that I've graduated, I miss that community, and it doesn't help that I'm broke and jobless. Oh, Jesus.
Let you get it through your thick skull that I'm Sheesh. Broke. Dead, flat, stony, broke. I've got $3.85 in my purse.
Guys should never feel insecure about their situation with women, man. They don't know where they're going. They misguided, undecided. They don't know where they're going. So you, as long as you have a direction, right? As long as you have direction, you're in a better position than them. Now, I was once jobless, but not for very long. But now she wants the belonging in the community and her sisterhood. It's time to grow up, baby. It's time to grow up. Sound effects too loud? All right, ninja, tearing your earphones up. All right, let me get to some super chats here. The mother sucking struggle continues. We got to help these sisters. She does. You know what? She is. Dude, this woman's going to get pregnant on you guys. Just to let you know. If you manage to let one skeet go by this woman, she getting knocked up. This woman is certified getting knocked up. This woman can have 15 babies on the spot. If this woman was in a different time, I can make a whole village out of this one woman. This one woman right here. I keep her pregnant and locked up in here. Come here. I need 8 babies. She can push them through. If she's not on birth control, this is a child support case coming. I'm just letting you know. Look at them. You can always tell a fertile woman. She has that. You can tell she's thick. All right. But her cheeks are going to give it away. Yeah, you getting her knocked up on pre-cum for sure. You are. Right? Her cheeks are going to give it away. That is the instant fertility. And normally her cheeks, I always say that. Check this out. I'm going to let y'all know how to see it. He said, I can have a litter of coaches. A woman's cheeks and her eyes, they almost always match her boobies. I'm just letting you know, man. This is stuff that you guys don't know. I'm giving you the insights of biology. When you draw these things, you would almost draw them similarly. If she has big eyes, big circular eyes, you can almost guarantee she got a full healthy set of breasts. And she probably got big old pepperoni size areolas and pencil erasers and nipples the size of pencil erasers. I can see it. It's almost inevitably. I know my women. If her cheeks are full like this, high cheekbones and they're full, this woman's fertile. Could knock her ass up. So don't play around. Do not let no semen go past this. This woman's going to have a baby on you. Okay. So I can already tell from here. And she going to blow up like the Goodyear blimp. But you already say big wide eyes, big high cheekbones, and they're full, like with baby fat, fertile. Now, Asian women tend to have smaller eyes, and they tend to have smaller boobies. They really don't have no big wide eyes. You know, their eyes be small and slanted out. They're going to have some smaller boobies. I know I be studying people. I be studying people like this. But if you're an artist, you know this. This is basically just telltale signs of high fertility in women. Obviously, if they're young. Just letting y'all know. All right, so always look at this. I know a lot of, and that's, y'all ninjas be liking thick girls. I always tell you, you're liking the most fertile women. And this is why y'all ninjas end up baby daddies. Because you're all trying to have sex with the most fertile women out here. You need to get you some flatbacks. Them women after 26, they have trouble having a baby. They have trouble keeping a baby. They have trouble even delivering babies. They can't get knocked up to save their lives. Some of them don't even have regular menstruation or periods. But if you have a woman that has very, very, like they got heavy periods, fertile Myrtle. All right. Fertile Myrtle. I could do a whole show on this. You could just give me pictures and I'd be like, yep, I can have 15 babies with that woman. 15. We could have our own village right there. Show me a flat back. I'll be like, Ninja, we're going to push out 2 and it's going to break her back. I'm going to have to go through fertility treatment. We're going to have to measure. All right. Anyway, and if you look at the hips, I can't see the hips, but the hips widening is a sign of her preparing herself for delivery of children. So this is why you will see women that are like a narrow waisted when they're young. They're like 21, 22, 23, even younger as an adult. They'll have slim hips. Their hips will be slim and tight. If she's delivered or capable of delivering babies as she matures, her pelvic is going to widen out. If she has had babies, this is why you typically see women who have had babies, their bottom trunk will be big and wide. All right. Even if she's slim, her hips will open up and able to let that baby sit in there and pass through her. And it doesn't really just go back. Those hips remain wide. So because her body's preparing, you can put more babies in her. She can knock them babies out. So these are things that you want to look for and why dudes like thick women, they typically almost always have had children. typically, this is general. They've always have had children already, and that body is widened up, and now the booty fat and the glutes have moved around it, and you guys like where the fat is sending. It's typical, very typical. All right, anyway. It's a weird world, man. But I'm a very much a observant person, so I observe these things. I like that's the thing that I be doing. I be watching people and be like, yeah, I could put 15 babies in that one. All right, anyway. Yep, no C-section needed. She gonna push that one, push it right out. But anytime you like thick women, you're liking the most fertile, probably the most fertile women. And that could be dangerous to you. So take that into consideration. Take that into consideration when you're pursuing women. All right. Anyway, shout out to De Niro. Trey Coelho says anatomy with CGA. All right. And again, it's general. It is not always true. JC says her cheeks only tell me she likes to eat moon pies. All right. Shout out to her. She definitely likes to eat moon pies. All right. What do we got here? Brandon Foster says breakdancing dad just said in his new video, if Maddie doesn't clean up her rack, he cutting her ass out of the wheel. Ring the bell. That's the only way to deal with kids, brothers. Cut they ass off. Right? Guys, kids don't do what you want them to do. And I'm talking about adult kids. If they not doing what you want them to do, there used to be a phrase that we got away from in our culture. And that used to be, the phrase used to be, damn, I done missed up the phrase. But you basically kicked out of the family or the wheel. Why did the phrase just slip my mind? I can't even think about it. But good for you. I think I already covered it. Back in the day, why can't I think of the phrase here? Just slipping my mind. Somebody help me out. Disown, thank you. Disown. You used to disown your kids. Disown. Oh, you gonna marry that person? All right, then go ahead, but you're disowned. Right? I no longer own you. I'm not responsible for you. People used to be ruthless. Excommunicate is another rule. All right, so it's another one. Disown. Now, what y'all do is keep family members around. And I've been done told y'all, not all family is good family. Okay? Not all family is good family. Disown. Ninja, disown her. Y'all don't want to do nothing? Okay, you don't got to do it. But don't think you in the will. Right? Don't think you're getting past nothing down. So that's kind of what we're doing right there. Yeah, you're no son of mine. You're going to marry that nigga. All right, anyway, I almost said it. It's fair game, guys. It's fair game. And people then call it, that's financial abuse. Nope, disown. You know how many people disown their kids? In Asian culture, they disown your ass. Jackie Chan disowned both of his kids. Now, he disowned them when they were adults, not when they were children. Okay. All right, Jackie Chan disowned his kids, his children. His children. I don't even know how to say it. Jackie Chan was like, okay, both of y'all people, kiss my ass. He disowned his son and daughter. Now, I'm not bragging about this, but what I'm saying is he's in a position to help, but look, he like, okay, y'all do you. You do you. Jackie Chan, complicated relationship with his two children, explained. All right, one child, there's his son, and he said, you're disowned. And then his daughter, where's his daughter? Let me scroll down. There's his daughter who's a Lily Lintlicker and married a woman. He was like, okay, that's all cool and all, but you disowned. Yeah, he said, that's cool and all. You can marry a woman, but Ninja, don't think you get a dime from me. Dr. Dre ended up disowning his 31-year-old daughter. He was like, that's it. I helped you. You don't want no help. All right, you mouthy, and you can't keep your mouth shut. You disowned. You know? 50 Cent disowned his son. Yep, he was like, you ain't my fucking kid. That's it, right? So a lot of people be like, but that's your old child. You need to do. Oh, man, like, no, man. If you're an adult and you want to do you. Now, as long if it comes at my expensive reputation, it is what it is, bro. You disown. Keep it moving, guys. I know, man. You guys are attached with this love shit. That's how you guys are attached with that. No matter what, through thick and thin. And then your kids or other family members dragging you down. Yeah, Prince Harry got disowned. They was like, okay, you want to marry her? Go ahead, do you. But we taking your title. We taking your land. We taking your salary. We taking all of that shit. Go ahead. We taking you out of the will. Go ahead. Marry her. Go. And they might be better, right? They might be better off. It might work out for them. And they might be like, hey, I had to get over my family disowning me. And they had to make their own way. So Prince Harry was another one that got disowned. So we do see it in our culture. And some parents be like, oh, I'll stick through it. D-Wade's like, I'll stick through it. Supporting your kids no matter what. All right. Nah, man, you don't have to do that. You don't have to do that. You can just keep it moving and be like, all right, fuck it. You do you, and I'm going to keep that shit moving. If they're adults. Remember, yeah, Lawrence Fishburne. There was another woman who was, I think, who was it? Not Jerry Seinfeld. It was, who was it? He had a daughter that wanted to do prawn. She was an adopted daughter of somebody. It was like Steven Spielberg. Steven Spielberg. I think his daughter started doing prawn. Guys, man, I tell you, man, I thank God for my kids. All right. Steven Spielberg's adopted daughter wanted to go do prawn. And he was like, okay, go ahead. But you cut off. I think it was Steven Spielberg. Yeah, this woman right here. All right. Like, dude, you work so hard to do whatever you need to do to protect your kids. And your kids go out doing goofy shit. He like, okay, yeah. You cut off, bitch. I'm cutting your ass off.
Now I got to cut you.
I'm cutting you off. So Steven Spielberg's adopted daughter, of course, the black one, the mulatto. She wanted to do OnlyFans and prawn. And then she dated some like scummy white guy. He was like, okay. He's like, okay. All right. I got no time for y'all asses. So be careful. Be always just vigilant. You don't have to be dragged down by people in your family just because they're related to you. All right. Anyway. What we at here? Shout out to DJ Latham says that first chick asked, where did the men? He says, where are the men? And he says, where are the men at? He says, look like Roy Lee, Rocky, Dennis from The Mask. Oh, no. Not The Mask. All right. Sorry. I was trying to read what that was there. Okay. So let me see here. She looked like the man in The Mask. Oh, my Lord. Jesus, man. That was hardcore. All right. That movie scared me. I saw that movie once. Oh, no. She does kind of look like that. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Okay. Anybody don't remember that movie? Kind of. I didn't like that movie. Oh, no. Yeah. So this is who he's saying she looks like. Oh, man, that's terrible, brothers. That's terrible. Why you do her that? Why you do her dirty like that? All right, hold on for a second. Where's the link here? You saying she look like that? Oh, ninja. I guess her head is shaped a little funny. Oh, man. Damn. I was like 10 years old when this movie came out. I was like, I'm not watching that. I think they tried to show it in my school. I was like, I don't want to watch that shit. All right. I was like, he looked crazy as hell. I was like, nah, I don't want to watch that. You know, your kid's going to turn out like that. I was like, no, they ain't. That was cold-blooded, DJ. He says, Justin S. says, Denver used to be one of the fittest cities. And he says, something went, you went to opening day. I guess there's a meme. There's like an icon there that I can't tell what it is. And he says, you went to opening day on Friday and Ninjas was down bad in public with some nasty gorditas. Anytime you see the worst women, when you see their man, it's almost inevitably going to be a black guy with them. All right. Dennis B. says, Lawrence Fishburne is the angry man. Convince me otherwise. All right, shout out to the angry man. Is that Lawrence Fishburne for real? All right, okay, they together? All right, they're the same person. All right, Deshaun Rose says, will she share her location? And says, it's always you should have fought harder instead of she's wrong for that. And the daughter of Kamora Lee Simmons, Flapjacks, this morning got me thinking about pancakes for breakfast. And he says, "Then get these damn likes up. You're understood, guys. Okay, you should have fought harder. Men that have to fight hard for their kids shouldn't even deserve, the kids shouldn't even live with the mother. Hambino Gambino, coach is telling the truth. My wife, he says, I met was a 24-year-old big-eyed Becky, top heavy, pregnant 4 months after we met. Now I have 4 kids. She's now 34. Coach tells no lies. I think I got this shit down, Pat. That's why I am here to teach the people what to look out for. But yes, if you have a woman, she has big eyes, big cheekbones, high cheekbones, and some body fat on her, and she's young, this woman is knock-up material. She would have been, and I dare say, she would have been the woman, a.k.a. the mammy, that would have got bred by slaves, all right? All right, they would have been like, all right, get Mandingo in here, knock her up. Put 5 babies in her. All right, shout out to you. 4 kids in 10 years. Ring the bell on this ninja. 4 kids in 10 years. All right, we're about to get back onto the show. I want to see how far did I get back on the other contributions here. We have a short week today. This week. Shout out to Dr. Thunder says, beauty is vain. Beauty is vain. And beauty is skin deep and ugly is to the bone. And what is this? Beauty is fleeting. Beauty is a commodity. It's a commodity that does not last. In fact, the movie Cinderella says it's the clock strikes midnight. Guys, beauty is only lasts so much. And you do get adapted. You adapt to beauty. So I know women. I know men that marry trophy wives and they're immune to her being a trophy wife. They forget. Shout out to Preston says the early termination clinic hasn't lost any funds. So they're definitely finding men. Price is wrong. Yes. Somebody finding them. This is the truth. Roof. UConn up 11-9. According to my TV screen, UConn should win this game. All right, let me see here. Short week, I'm going to do a little bit of moving around. April is my travel month, so I'm going to be been around the world and Ass Ninja. Be ready. You never know where I'll pop up. You never know where I'll pop up. I might pop up in your spot. All right, last one says, did I get Schedule P? That's a co-sponsorship. Schedule P.
I'm ready.
He said, JC says, my crotch hurts after looking at Ayoko Lee's crepes. Yeah. Little skinny booty ass chick. Let's get to it. Soft guy era. Apparently, this gentleman here, I want to make sure I credit the right guy for coming up with the soft guy era. Now, I might be wrong. So, unfortunately, I'm going to just have to say that this guy is one of the guys that made it up. I think he's one of the guys. Let me see here. If he's not, maybe we can clear it up. I do have 2 gentlemen here that have come up with the soft guy era. And apparently, it's going viral on TikTok. What is the soft guy era? Let me let this guy explain it.
We done with the 90s.
Oh. Like a carnival. All right. So, hold on. He's selling gear. So, okay. Oh, okay.
Soft guys are not expensive to take care of. Like, I don't have any problem paying all the bills and taking care of you. The problem that I have with these soft men is that they won't submit. Mm-hmm. They won't listen.
All right. And so, I guess, hold on for a second. I'm going to have to figure this out. All right. I want to find the original soft pot. And he's basically saying drizzle, drizzle. In place of sprinkle, sprinkle. So sprinkle, sprinkle, and all of these things are related to the woman that's been along for a while. Here's the original.
Listen,
one.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm just so tired of being a strong, independent man. I just want a woman to come into my life and just take all the weight off my shoulders. I can't do this alone. I'm tired of being a strong, independent man. I'm tired of it. Like, I just want to be at home, cook and clean, and then when my woman gets off of work, I can just give her her meal, and she can just lay down while I rub her feet. I just want to be her housekeeper. I don't want to go to work anymore. I'm tired of working these 50, 60-hour weeks, and I'm paying all my own bills. I'm just so tired. I can't handle it anymore. I can't. I just really can't do it anymore. So,
oh,
all right, y'all. So we know it's 2024.
All right, so let me stop, man. I hate TikTok on my computer because I touch the mouse and it just goes jumping around. So let me go to this guy right here. He has a baller belly, Sean. He says, "Drizzle, drizzle. 2024 is the year of the soft guy." By the way, these guys are joking. Just so we know. These guys are joking. What they're doing is giving women back what women put out there. Now, I had another video, but it seems to have gotten deleted, where women literally put community guideline strikes on these guys. So women put community guideline strikes as hate speech of what these guys are saying. So they're just trolling. They're not being honest. They're just trolling women. Where's my video here? Let's see what we got here.
Excellent provider male era. We're in our soft guy era, okay? Drizzle, drizzle. Listen, I don't know who needs to hear this, but until that woman asks you to be her husband, you don't have to do husband-like things. Stop giving these women husband advantages and amenities, and you're still a boyfriend. Until that ring is on your finger, you shouldn't be doing anything, period. Drizzle, drizzle. Like, y'all be so caught up on getting with Dusties and all that, you need to start going after their moms. See, I know a lot of y'all think that older women may not be that much attractive or whatever the case may be, but there's a lot of good-looking older women. And I feel like you guys can deal with these older women who is going to take care of you and treat you like a king that you are. Drizzle, drizzle.
Drizzle, drizzle.
Now, there's a point where as a man in your soft guy era, you shouldn't be pumping your own gas. You shouldn't be cleaning out your car.
No, no.
You shouldn't be having to change your tires. You shouldn't be having to put air in your tires. You shouldn't have to mow the grass. That's all the responsibilities of your woman. The moment you become a husband, then things change. But until then, that woman should be taking care of everything. And you shouldn't be showing her no reason on why she should stick with you for the rest of her life. And in hopes that she makes you her husband. Drizzle, drizzle.
Drizzle.
You need to stop giving out so much to these women.
Oh,
like,
no.
Y'all giving up the dookie.
Oh, the dookie.
Quick as hell. And y'all dropping it off. And these women are not appreciating it. I think you need to hold out. Even if you had sex with 100, 200 women, you need to hold out and make that woman wait until she shows you that she's capable and that she's loving enough for you to give your body to her. You know, because at the end of the day, it's all about us. It's all about us. We just want our equal rights as men. So,
all right.
So, drizzle, drizzle.
Drizzle, drizzle. All right. I want to give him his props because I think he's one. I can't tell which one of these guys are the creator of this one. And, one guy did a video showing that he got a community guideline strike that they banned his video. And I can't remember which one of the gentlemen because they do look similar. Oh, here it is, right? No. Okay, I can't find it. All right, so this guy, he's growing it. He's growing his channel. Soft Guy Era Movement.
Listen, I don't think y'all understand what this whole soft guy era movement is really doing. It's really exposing that a lot of women play ignorant to men's feelings and how they treat men. Because if you look at some of these comments and even the responses I got from my video, there's literally women answering their own questions with their own logic. So that means they're fully capable of doing the right thing. They just choose to do the wrong thing because there's nobody to stand up for men. We have no public voice.
Yep.
Even though we created and did everything.
Right.
We have no public voice for our mental shit that we go through.
Correct.
And this whole soft guy era movement just shows you that women know what they do to us.
Right.
Women know what they're capable of and what they're actually indulging in, and they don't give a fuck.
Right.
They don't care. Like, really look at all the comments. Really look at these stitches and reaction videos. They like, oh, they really want to be us. They really want... Because what a lot of women don't understand is that they benefit from men's hard work.
For real.
Whether they want to accept it or not.
Yes.
That stoplight, man. That police officer, man. That firefighter, a man. Like, there's things that they benefit from us that they just don't want to admit to. And that's cool, but we know the truth.
All right, and so this guy even said in the comment section, this, and it's an older guy, he says, don't explain it, just keep playing. And I agree. I agree. This is a good flip the script kind of conversation, because normally when men flip the script, this is why I always tell you, don't explain anything to women. Just flip the script. Just pivot. Just go focus on your life. But when you flip the script, you will see their hypocrisy. And then he's saying, look, the comment section is showing you the hypocrisy and double standard, and you're answering your own question by me playing back what you say to men. You've been saying this to men, and we're going to play it back to you and see how it sounds. All right. And he's finding out that these people have one of these gentlemen. I'm going to say both of their names, and I'm not saying who created it. All right. But let me see here.
A lot of y'all dudes need to stop trying to play it off and just admit it. Like, a lot of y'all dudes really do want a man. Because I be seeing, like,
yeah,
dudes getting online, talk about how they in their soft boy era, and they want to be.
All right. Okay. Damn, I hate when TikTok. Guys. I hate when TikTok does that. But anyway, Scarface Mark is the one gentleman. Let me go ahead and give him some props. You can follow them. Soft Guy Era co-founder. All right, so Scarface Mark is one gentleman. The other gentleman's name is Baller Belly Sean. He says drizzle, drizzle. So these are two men that are like in their mid-20s, and this is great. This is great. I like it. I like it. I approve of it because nobody's thought of this, and some of these guys have thought of this, and they're playing back what women are saying, and now women can't handle it. You guys really want men. You must be gay. You're sassy and all that stuff. They're telling what women should do. You should take care of us. I love it. So drizzle, drizzle. Let's give those guys some TikTok or some social media love, and I'm liking that these young men are trying to find out new ways to spread the message of the unfairness that are going on in the dating marketplace. And of course, these guys don't look like they have trouble getting women. One of the big things that they say is that these men just, they can't get women, so they're mad. Well, I'm going to just say here and pause. These guys don't look like they can't get women. Like, for me, people say that to me, and I'm like, I'm literally here talking about, my problem was never getting women. All right, now, did I always get the women that I liked? No. All right, but I actually was married and had kids. So, I mean, that debunks that just off face value. But I support these guys with the soft guy era just trolling the internet. And yes, some women got triggered and reported it as community guidelines violation. I don't know which one of them did, but my video disappeared. Let me see here. Do I got some more show? Yes, it's an evil world. Yes, we got two more things, and then we'll do the main event. It's an evil world we live in. Here we go.
It's an evil world we live in.
The update on Jonathan Majors. You guys heard this earlier in our stream. Jonathan Majors breaking. He avoids prison time, which I didn't think he was going to get any prison time. He's sentenced to 1 year of counseling in a domestic violence assault. Everybody knows he had that white woman chasing him down the streets in New York. She claimed to have her finger. She hurt her finger, and she bonked her head. She claimed to have had been violated. She also was charged with domestic violence, but was not prosecuted for such. She got nothing. This was an absolute farce of a case. But of course, we have to take accountability. He messed up, and now he has to pay the piper. All right, so there it is right there. After he was convicted, he's been sentenced to 1 year of domestic violation. We call it over here counseling after being convicted last year of assaulting and harassing his ex, Grace Jabari. And I think Henry Resilient reported that it's 52 weeks of domestic assault counseling. Okay. 52 weeks of domestic assault counseling, man. This is an absolute disgrace. 52 weeks. I would have served a week in jail. All right. And got up out of there. All right. So here we go right here. 52 weeks of him dealing with, you know, being gaslit, and you really understand he's probably got to go to a morgue where a woman got choked out, you know, all of these things. Or look at a guy went choked her out. Okay. He's looking at her like, oh God, he's got to deal with being indoctrinated. Do you really understand? He's going to have like five chunky women that claim they were abused by their husband. Do you really understand? I was important to us, and it's us and that, and what you did was horrible. Do you understand? You hurt her finger. You bonked her head. She was chasing you because you were a villain. He got to deal with that. Angry women yelling at him. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't even do nothing to them. You know what I mean? Like, he's got to make a commercial. You got to make a commercial. Sitting up there. No, but like, do it live.
We'll do it live. Okay. No. We'll do it live. Do it live.
Yeah.
I'll write it and we'll do it live.
Yeah. They'll do it live and they'll have to make a commercial. Don't beat up women. Even if she takes your phone and you cheating on her and she chasing you down the street, don't beat them up. They gonna have to do that shit. That ninja gonna be in there like, all right, you're a monster, and men do this to them. Oh my god, he gonna be like, oh lord, why did I? He was like, I'll serve a week in jail than to be abused like this. This is crazy. Shout out to our brother Ron in the building. Thank you, sir, over on the Cash App. It's the evil world we live in, gentlemen.
It's an evil world we live in.
All right, we got this. Remember, I gave you the biology lesson. This just scared the shit out of you. Fresh, listen up. The human female cervix can open, can store sperm to release it over time. What did I tell you? We told you that the ovulation cycle typically is a day or two tops. We also tell you that sperm can live for 24 hours. So if you shoot up the club and you're cream pieing women, this is a major, major conversation that we need to talk about. You're cream pieing women and she gets pregnant. It is that the human female cervix can store sperm, this doctor says, until the ovulation, as long as it's within a 48-hour period.
Human female reproductive tract can store sperm for days and then release it to allow a pregnancy to occur when ovulation is happening a few days later. It's true. There's a lot of internet myths about this, but they're actually confirmed. Now, a lot of species can do this besides humans. This is the Reddit post. The uterus has little chambers for storing sperm. And this is what they look like in the human female. This is the cervical crypt with the mucus coming out of it. Humanity. That's where the sperm is stored, and then it can be released over time.
Other animals
do this too. Mice for hours, dogs and horses for days, turtles for a year, and leafcutter ants can store the sperm for a decade.
That's what them guts looking like in there.
Humanity.
That's what them guts looking like when you shooting up the club. And y'all shooting millions of spermatozoid in there. All right. You shooting all that sperm in there and you wonder how they getting pregnant. Look at them guts. Why you rearranging them guts? That's why they call it the penis flytrap, right? You rearranging them guts and you shooting up the club. That's what happens in there, brother. You should thank me for the sex ed videos here that I've been telling you about. We aim to help men. Guys, you guys got to be careful out here, man. We're animals at the end of the day. We're very close. We're mammals. You know, we're higher thinking mammals. We do everything that the animals do, man. And our body functions what we call autonomically, which is automatic. Like a woman doesn't have to think about this. This happens within the body. The body's an amazing thing. This also makes you want to believe in a God, right? Because if you don't believe in God and you look at how the body's designed, how efficient it is, and how you're able to be healthy and you have viruses that can actually strengthen your immune system. The body's an amazing thing. So be careful out here.
These are animals that can mate once and then ovulate and have reproduction months or years later. But it actually can happen in the human too. The cervical crypts are little parts of the cervix designed to be a storage space for the sperm where it then can slowly release it over time. They can live for 5 days and pregnancy can occur even when ovulation occurs.
Wow, man. I tell you, man. Man, it explains it. It explains it because you're like, you weren't ovulating. You were close to your period or you were previous to your ovulation, right? And then you don't get it. You're like, the time-wise don't match up. But man, especially if you cream pieing somebody 30 days consecutively, right? Can you say cream pie on YouTube? I'm trying to even just stay here, man. I'm telling you, man.
It's an evil world we live in.
All right, your little swimmer's in there just chilling, like, to the side, like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? She got me trapped over in here, ninja, but I'm going to get out soon. They smell an egg. They be like, all right, you be sitting over there, the eggs be. Be careful, gentlemen, man. It's an evil world out here, brothers. Look out, man.
It's an evil world we live in.
Y'all got us. This is what we doing, man. We got to teach y'all, brothers, man. We got to teach y'all, brothers. We got main event coming up right now. Main event. We'll read this list right here. Main event. Give me the bell. All right, Kevin Durant on why he's single. This list has allegedly been presented on the internet as a list from Kevin Durant. Now, I'm going to just tell you, I'm going to say Kevin Garnett every now and then because for some reason, Kevin Garnett is easier to remember than Kevin Durant. But Kevin Durant gives his reasons on why he's single. Anybody know his personality is very loose. He's somewhat insecure. He has, you know, fake accounts that he had been discovered trolling people. And he's an easygoing guy. He's not a swag guy. He doesn't make great efforts to dress. I mean, he barely brushes his beard or his hair. He's kind of just like a guy that's just him. And he focuses on basketball. But apparently this list was posted and later deleted. But somebody got a screenshot. Reasons why I'm single. Are we ready for this, man? Let me see here. We're ready.
Y'all ready for this?
Let's see what he's talking about here. And do you match up? Now, you would think he would have an easy time on a dating marketplace. Not so much. He says, I'm a massive overthinker. Okay. And by the way, he's been raised primarily by his mother, so this will make sense. Number two, I care too deeply. All right. Yes. 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 I care very deeply. All right. He cares too deeply. That's sweet. I'm a be safe type of guy. I'm a be safe type of guy. What does that mean? What does that mean?
And that's you.
Message me when you get home. Have a good night type of guy. Please, I'm wondering, did he come up with this shit? Is this real? Who else came up with this? There's some sucker for love ninjas out here too. All right. You're a be safe type of guy. Be safe, honey. This is aftercare. It's okay. Message me when you get home. All right. I have so much energy. Okay, that explains why you're an athlete. I give my all to people who don't give me half back. That's dating. That's women. That is definitely women. You're dating. That's what dating is. You give a lot. She gives a little back. Now, eventually the tide should turn where she gives way more back. But some women don't agree with that. Some women think you're supposed to keep giving and then she gives you a little bit as a reward. Like there's a thing where a guy said, the key to getting women to treat you well is if you treat them well first. So the transactional relationship initiates with you got to treat her well and then she treats you well. You treat her poorly, she treats you poorly. I think that's not good. That's negative. Especially in long-term relationships. I don't understand why she can't treat me well. Why my behavior dictates how she treats me. Like, if she really likes me, that shouldn't be. It should be reciprocal. It should be not tit for tat. Not tit for tat. Obviously, if I treat you bad, she's probably going to stick around and play a victim. But no, I don't agree with that. All right, this is how ninjas get finessed out here. You sucker for love, ninjas. He also says right here, I would do anything to make someone happy, even if it means I get hurt in the process. I cannot believe that this is this ninja. I can't believe he wrote this. All right. I would do anything. You asked me to anything, ass ninja. To make someone happy, even if it means I get hurt in the process. That's despicable. That is disgraceful. Please, Kevin Durant, tell me you did not make up this list. Okay. I need reassurance. No, man. No. I need reassurance all the time. Dude, this definitely sounds like a woman wrote this list. Somebody's got to clue me in, man. This list was attributed. It's a cut and paste here. There's no way, man. There's no freaking way you wrote this. All right. I need reassurance all the time. I did tell you he was insecure. I did tell you he was insecure, but I don't think this is his list. But he does exhibit some insecure behaviors, especially with people online talking about him. In fact, there was a case, well, not a case, but what happened was, I guess on Twitter or Instagram, he actually had a, what do you call it? He had another account, a Finsta, or he had a fake Twitter where he was debating people that were talking shit about him online. Now, he's an NBA player, but he created another account. He was caught. And he was defending stuff about Kevin Durant. So he went online. I mean, I think that is nuts. For me, I don't even read what people say about me. I'd be like, I don't want to even know. I don't even want to even know. Yeah, the burner account. He had a burner account. He got caught with a burner account. I don't know how he got caught. Let me see here. Kevin Durant. This list is very, very sensitive. He probably watching this show. Let me see, where was his burner account? This is according to Reddit. Let's see, this was 7 years ago, so this is old news. Kevin Durant uses a second account to defend himself on Twitter. Today he forgot the switch. All right, so somebody got the screenshots here. Hold up, let me see here. All right, so here's an example right here. All right, he forgot the switch. Oh, by the way, this is real, guys. This really happened. This is not fake. So somebody was calling him, talking about him. Man, I respect the hell out of you, but you give me one legitimate reason for leaving OKC other than getting a championship. And he forgot the switch. He commented under his own name. He didn't like the organization or playing for Billy Donovan. His roster wasn't that good. It was just him and Russ. Now, he was supposed to reply under his fake account, but he literally replied and talked to himself about himself in third person, and he got caught. And they, of course, man, screenshot, man. That's why I don't reply to comments, brothers. These screenshots are deadly. Look, he replied, imagine taking Russ off the team, see how bad they were. KD can't win a championship with those cats. He got caught. Oh, no. Man, that's cold, man. Not even women do this shit. I'm sorry. I take that back. This is something that women do. I should say that. Like, I don't even know what people even comment on my page. I just don't even want to know. Like, I appreciate the supportive comments, just to let you know. But, of course, doing social media is very tough, especially when you're spread across multiple platforms. It's tough to hear what people think about you, especially if it's negative. You're like, oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. All right. He got caught at 4K. So, yeah, KD got caught at 4K with a burner account. So you kind of see where he is and where he's coming from and why he would probably say something like this. Man almighty. So, yeah, these athletes, these celebrities, they use burner accounts and they be arguing about people about their own shit. He says it looks intentional. He's been caught doing it multiple times. I don't know, man. Oh, man, that's cold. Let me see if he had another one. All right. Anyway. Oh, by the way, he actually expressed why he wasn't considered top five all time in NBA. So he's definitely a sensitive guy. Top five all time. Let me see here. Let's see right there. Yeah, he's talking about why am I not top five all time. Do you think he's top five all time, Kevin Durant? He certainly has a case. He certainly has a case. I would have a case for him being top 10 all time. I think he slept on. Thank you for leaving good comments, though. I appreciate that. But you got to think, man, I got to protect my mental health. I have to protect my mental health. I can't read everybody's comments, man. It would be traumatizing. I'd rather make more content. All right. And I would suggest for you guys, somebody said, no, I'm not top five. All right. Why not top five? He's a good player. Not top five. Top 10, I could say he could get a fight for. Top 20 for sure. Let me see here. He's got some more to list here. He says he needs reassurance. Ooh, that's feminine as hell, bruh. Reassurance? Mm-mm. Quote, I'll push you away when I feel like the energy isn't reciprocated. That's fair. That's fair. This is why he's single? And he says, I love old school romance, and that's just not a thing for our generation. Old school romance. Yeah, that ship is sailed, guys. Romance is for sale. That ship is sailed. Now, I'm going to tell you this. I know a lot of people don't agree with me, but this marketplace is not set up for that anymore because there's not a lot of things you can do that would be romantic that doesn't come at a great cost. And it's not because of dating and relationships. It's because the corporations basically have monopolized everything and everything costs. So there used to be a time where you can take a blanket out and she could bring the wine and cheese and you bring the bread and the ham or the turkey, right? And y'all could have a little walk in the park. Today's women don't want that. They want the fine dining. They want good experiences. They want balloon rides. And today you can't really, like, we're city dwellers. We live in cities. So you can't just be like, we'll go on a horseback riding and then you take her to your horse stable, right? You're a city dweller. You dwell in an apartment building. So everything comes at a cost, and the cost is rising with inflation. So these fantasies, unfortunately, women think they're entitled to, seem to be getting out of hand. And so romance is romantic things that mostly women want. It's just an investment for men, and they don't see the need to invest. There are some women that will go on coffee dates. I mean, listen, those are outliers. That's not the normal average woman, especially then when you're talking about women in their prime. Women in their prime years, which we have determined to be somewhere in the 21, underage 21-year-old, up until 28 at most, these women want to get dressed up and wear their high heels and grease up their legs and put cocoa butter on their oil and put their wig on or curl their hair and put their glitter on their titties and get their little handbag. And they want to feel cute. They want to feel cute. They want to go out to nice places and restaurants, and it makes sense because they're in their prime. Why should they wait until they're 30 to experience this and wait till men get their shit together? Unfortunately, from the woman's perspective, she doesn't realize that men their age don't have their shit together, and they would not be able to afford these type of romantic deals. You just don't. Men aren't just there financially. So they would have to meet a guy that is there in her age group financially, which is a small percentage of men, or date or older men, or try to chase ballers. So both stories, both sides, it makes sense. But he wants romance. From who? From who are you possibly going to enjoy romance from? Probably gold diggers. And they're not going to be authentic. And once they see you paying for this, they're going to want that. So it's tough for him when he wants romance. He wants an old school romance. Also, we've gotten away from dating people close to us. And we are now dating people further away from us. When I was in college basketball, one of the things that we would do is we would never look at the kids that are in our neighborhood unless they were phenomenal. So, but every kid in the neighborhood thought, hey, I'll go to that school. So they'll always knock on the door. Hey, listen, I'm not an all-state player. I'm all-city fifth team. I'll come play for you. And we're like, no, I need some first-team all-cities. So what we would do is we would go all over the damn nation trying to get people to come to a school that they barely even heard of because they were good. And so that's what we tried to do, which pissed off the locals. Today, that's how we do dating. We do dating like this. There's people in our social circle, our churches, our schools, neighborhoods, community centers. You have it. You name it. Most people rarely date in those. They don't date in that circle. There's always a better guy in Atlanta. There's always a hot chick in Boise. There's always a nice flat back over in Montana, in Missoula. There's also a fat chunky chick in Kansas City. Right. So men and women are typically trying to go way out here. Ninja, y'all going over to Asia. Y'all going way out of your reach. And then you find a diamond in the rough over there that thousands of men and women have passed on. Right. They passed on it. I don't want her. So for her, she's like, I like this guy. He lives in LA. Like, and he does this and he does that. Like, what are we doing? It's getting way out of hand. It's getting way out of hand where your best bets are kind of where you are, or you have to move to an area where you think you can find the best suitable mate. And it starts in high school. It starts in high school. What happens in high school? High school, freshman, sophomore year, maybe freshman year, they're all cool with the boys, normally the sophomores and juniors. Every now and then they'll mess with some seniors, but they'll start getting excited. They go to eighth grade and ninth grade, all the boys at my school. Then after they get ran through freshman year, now they start seeing the other football team, the other school's basketball team. Now they start meeting people from the other school. Or every now and then they'll go to the after school spot or a dance where the other school's kids come in. And then there's like, oh, the kids at that school are better than the boys at my school. The girls at that school are better than the girls at my school. So then all of a sudden, it's the people over there. Those people are better. Meanwhile, at their school, those girls hate those guys. At that school, them boys then already ran through them girls. And so the girls over there or the guys over there, nobody worries about. They want the girls at your school. The girls at that school want the boys at my school. All right. And so forth and so on. It starts right there. Now, everybody wants to reach out and find a guy, bring him over there, find a girl way over there. You go to Michigan, all the girls, the good girls are at Michigan State. You go to UCLA, all the hot girls are at USC. And they're just simply new. You don't know them and you don't know their quirks. When you're in your social circle, not only do you know them, you know their history, you know their quirks, you know how goofy they are. You see them when they down bad, you see them when they're glammed up. So then you can really judge who the person is. That's the best way to judge. Yep, somebody said the grass is greener. That's the best way to judge a person, not in their highlights. Their highlights. All right, the girls at USC are better than the girls at UCLA. That's what you will say if you go to UCLA. Oh, those girls are better. Why? Because you see them when they're good looking. You see them when they're amped up. You don't see them when they pissy, when they wake up in the bed at the dorm. You don't see them fucking other guys. You don't see none of that. And social media has taken that to another level. Dating app took that to one level. Social media took that to another level. So now men and women look on social media. Well, none of the girls look like her in my neighborhood, but I want a girl like that. I want a girl like that. In my days, this used to be the video vixen model. Everybody remembers the video vixen models. These girls will be coming in and they do the slow motion shit where they walking in and they got that hair bouncing and they walk in and then the angles, there's 15 camera angles in a 5-second clip and they hit you with the thigh shot, the booty shot, the hair shot, the look in slow motion, turning like that with the sunglasses shot. They get her licking a lollipop shot. All right. And they hit you with bam, bam, bam. They hit you with that imagery. They get a picture of her toes, her calves. They hit you with all that shit. And you be like, oh, I want a girl like that. I want a girl like that. Well, guys, she don't look like that 24/7. It took her 3 hours of makeup and hair to look like that, maybe more. All right, so you see the vibrant thing girl walking by. Hold on, let me pull her up. You see the vibrant thing girl walking by, and you like, I remember my boy, the vibrant thing. Let me see, where is it at? You see the vibrant thing girl walk by. I remember my boy, we was used to watch videos, and he used to be like, I need a girl like that. He was a goofy. I was like, Ninja, you ain't never getting a bitch like that. Never. He was like, if I could have a girl like that. I was like, Ninja, Where is she at? Let me see if I can get the. Okay, here it is right here. I'm going to get a copyright for this, but I'm going to play it for y'all brothers right here. Yeah, there it is right there. Look at the ass slowed down. Woo, ninja. She thick. Look at the ass shot right here. Look at this shit right here. You watching the booty, you're like, I want a girl like that. Woo, ninja had y'all. This was before Instagram, y'all. This is for before Instagram. Ninjas used to be watching music videos like Squashy. He was dreaming. He was like, I need a girl like that. Let me see if I can find the Viber girl thing here. A good one. This girl right here. Oh, she a baddie. This chick right here. She one of my favorites of all time. I did a video on her too. Man, this girl right here was unbelievable. Right here. Here we go. Yeah. Yeah. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing. A vibrant thing. Look at y'all. Check it. Look at y'all. Check it. Look at y'all. Check it. Look at y'all. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Such a vibrant. That girl right there? I want a girl like that. I want a girl like this. I want her. I wanna. Yes, I want that, baby. I wanna. Gimme. Ninja, I'm starving.
Yeah, that brother's starving.
Ooh, wait. I actually have a video on her where I did it. She's actually still beautiful, but she definitely blown up like the Goodyear blimp. I want a girl like that. I want a girl like that. Getting back. Check it. Look at me. Check it. Look at y'all. Check it. Look at y'all. Yo, yo, yo. Such a vibing thing. Remember that? Man, I tell you, bruh. Yeah.
Yeah, that brother's star.
And this was before BBLs. Titty implants was out. This was before BBLs. This is before BBLs. Oh, man, I tell you, man. But that's what guys used to do. You know what I mean? Like, guys would get mesmerized by these imageries, and you would want a girl like that. But other women wouldn't compare. Other women would compare at all. Yeah, man. So that's how guys look at social media. That's how guys want women. And women are doing that too. Women are doing that too. They're seeing successful men. They're also seeing successful men with women. And they're like, well, where are all those guys at? Right? This woman says it right here. Where are all the guys? Look. All right, where are all the guys?
Late 20s, early 30s. Where are we finding men?
Where are we finding men? Where the man at? All right, so that's kind of what's happening here. And I think Kevin Durant is living this on steroids. And I think it's throwing off the dynamics between men and women. My best information is that I think men and women should date social circle. Date within a 5 mile radius. 5 mile radius. That's where you should be dating. Okay, because social media is taking it everywhere. That's why Passport Bros, now that their Passport Bro game is kind of dead, because it's not dead, but what's happening is those women have Instagram. Those women have TikTok. Like, these women aren't ignorant to the rest of the society and what women can get. So, yeah, you can still get them for 1,000 baht and 500 baht. You can still get them there. But what's happening is those women in the Philippines where everybody was going, Colombia, they got Instagram too. They got all the shit that they can see what American men are doing, and they can hear American women, and they can see American men are tired of American women, so they can play up on that. I say 5 mile radius is where your best bet is. He says, why limit yourself? Because you're really making it more difficult for yourself. You're really making it more difficult. Now, you can move around, but if you really wanted to find a mate, okay, you would find it in the radius. You would find it in your social circle. Another reason why women don't do this is because men know them already. They're aware. Their reputation is not as high. So she can't. And men do this too. She can't lie to other people. if I, it, guys, who's from Los Angeles? Put a one in the chat if you're from Southern California. Or Southern California. Southern California people might know this because Southern California is kind of spread out. And it's a bunch of small suburbs mixed into whatever. So if you're in Southern California, which is LA, Ventura County, Orange County, San Diego, then you have San Bernardino and Riverside. Put a one in the chat. Put a one in the chat if you're from Southern California. Okay. In Southern California, this is how crazy the game is in Southern California. This includes Ventura County, Los Angeles, Orange County, San Bernardino, San Diego, and Riverside. What'll happen is these places are hard to get through during the day. If you left at 2 o'clock in any one of these places, it would take you through 6 o'clock to get to where you're going. It could take you to 6 o'clock. Now, these places are 50-mile radius. 50-mile radius. Sometimes 75 miles if you go from Los Angeles to San Diego. But really, we're talking about a 50-mile radius. However, if you drive to any of these places, it could take you hours to get there. Just imagine, you're 35 miles away, and it could take you 2 hours. 2.5 hours if you left during traffic. Unfortunately, and I live most of my life in this area, you're looking at the map, and you say, okay, you're in San Gabriel Valley. I'm in Orange County. At 9 p.m., I could probably make that drive and get there in 45 minutes, 50 minutes without traffic, all on the freeways. It'd take me 3 or 4 freeways, but I can get there. However, it's a world's away. But that's how people in Los Angeles, Southern California date. They date in these crazy radiuses, and they have these relationships with some odd woman and some odd man, and you're spread apart like this, where it takes you hours so that the investment to get to someone is significant. I say this is counterproductive. Okay. This is probably not the best. This is not the best way to do it because what will happen is you're talking about an area that has 10 million people and you're dating someone 2.5 hour drive away. That's a 35 mile drive. 2.5 hour drive, and it's a 20-mile, 25, 30-mile, 20. You would think it's close, but it's not. But there's 10 million people right in these areas, maybe 20 million, and you pick someone way the fuck over there, 2.5 hour drive away, and then you got to balance a relationship with this 2.5 hour drive in between. And then that includes when you get off of work and got to commute home and then got to commute to them or vice versa. They commute to you. The shit is insane. It's absolutely goofy, but people do this. And I'm like, dude, your radius is right here. You live in San Fernando Valley. You live in North Hollywood. Why are you dating someone in San Diego? You live in Thousand Oaks. Why are you dating someone in Riverside? But people do it. People do it. Why is traffic so bad? Because everybody want to live in California. All right. That's what it is. All right. But so people then make it complicated. Why can't there's 10, 20 million people. Why can't you find someone right there? Like, why can't you find someone very much closer to you? People don't do it. They go all the way out and got to fool and finesse somebody way the fuck over there. That's basically what happens here. All right, so here's an example here. This is an example. This is Southern California right here. All right, Southern California is a mess. All right, so let me just show you here. I don't know if you can see my mouse. Can you guys see my mouse moving? This is the areas that I just identified. Let me see if you can see my mouse. You guys cannot see my mouse. All right, so I lived in these areas for 30 years. All right, and I've lived in either up here in Thousand Oaks, all the way down in Orange County. And I've lived in Hawthorne and Inglewood right there. I lived all over. And I lived in the San Fernando Valley, Agoura Hills. I've lived in all these places. But I want you to look. I wish you can see my mouse. But this is the coastline. You see this area. It says Thousand Oaks. It's in the upper left-hand corner, Thousand Oaks. You'll have a person live in Thousand Oaks, and they'll be dating someone in Huntington Beach down here. Thousand Oaks, Huntington Beach. Now, you would have to take three freeways, to get over there. And it's nonstop bumper-to-bumper traffic. And by the way, there's beautiful people here. There's beautiful people. These are some of them. I mean, these are naturally like a 7 would be a knockout in Tupelo, Mississippi. A 7. A woman that's a 7 in Thousand Oaks, a 7 in Newport Beach would be a 10, a 9 in Tupelo. So these are not ugly people. You're living around somewhat beautiful people that are, the average are better than normal in most places, other than Miami, New York, and such. And if you don't know where they are and you went to LA and you saw all homeless people and crackheads and average people, you weren't in the right place. They're not out in the streets walking. They're tucked away in these sleepy little towns. So there's millions of people. How many people live in Southern California? How many people live in Southern California? 23 million. 23 million. And you will have people that cannot find a mate and dating all across the fucking map. 23 million people and just in Southern California. So that's how you can see where that map makes sense. 23 million people right in here. And people just can't find people right in their neighborhood, right around the corner. Why? Maybe because they might not live in a good area, or they want to have hypergamy, or, you know, people in their neighborhood know them. So then I'm a person from San Diego, and I drive all the way up here to Anaheim because there's a woman out there that likes me on Bumble and Tinder. You see what I mean? So I'll drive all the way up here, leave fucking San Diego, and go to Anaheim. People are doing this. I know a woman that I said one time, she was all the way up in Thousand Oaks, and I was in Newport. And I was like, hell no. She was like, what? I see guys all the time in San Diego. This bitch driving down to San Diego for some deals, Nick. Talking about that ain't no long drive. I'm like, you ain't gonna catch me going back and forth. So that's kind of what's happening with people. Their area is not good enough for a variety of reasons. Maybe I'll do a show on it. So then you get the men that are up and higher in scale. You go Newport, Pacific Palisades, La Jolla. So they start targeting and positioning in the higher income areas. And they'll go, I want a guy that lives in Newport. I want a guy that lives in Dana Point, San Clemente. But what happens is, this is what happens. These are the top 20% of men economically. They have reach of the greater amount of this 29 million people, or however many women there are single. So every woman I meet and I say, I live in Newport Beach. Okay. I live in Newport Beach. If I tell a woman that, their eyes get big like this. Oh, Newport Beach, you say. And you could just reel them in. Now, when you reel them in, you live in an apartment in Newport Beach, or you live in a condo. It's still better than them dating a guy in Riverside. So it's a wild thing that you're seeing, that these women keep falling for it. Oh, wow. Okay. Maybe he might be in a good situation. Maybe. Or you might do vice versa. I live in Newport Beach. I would never date a woman that lives in Riverside. Okay, so there it is right there. Okay, I live in Newport Beach. I would never date a woman in Corona. Why? She's kind of accustomed to a different lifestyle. Or Moreno Valley or some shit like that. All the way in the inland. This is called inland, where you see San Bernardino, Riverside. This is where Fontana, Fontucky. This is where all the meth and the crackheads be at. All right, this is where it's 110 degrees in the summertime. So you see that Corona, Riverside, Moreno Valley, Fontana, San Bernardino. You don't want to be out there. Shout out to my brothers out there. All right. By the way, prime real estate is on the coast. So if you live on the coast, that's where the better weather is. That's where it's a little bit cooler. That's where the mansions are. That's where the high rent district is. So you live on the coastline, you have an advantage. When you live inland, it's a little bit more, you know, It's a little bit more of a risk. Although there are some places inland that are high rent district as well. All right. Shout out to everybody. But if you live in any of these places, you walk outside, there's millions of people. There's no shortage of people, but then people can't find people to date because they're dating all over the map. It's sad. Anyway. Inland. You want to live on the coast. You want to live on the coast, but the coast living is expensive. You want to live on the coast, you're talking about at least $4,500 in rent to get a rental, $4,500. All right, maybe even higher than that. You want to buy a house, you're talking about well over $1 million for a starter home. And you're also talking about homes in the $5, $10, $15, $20, $30, $40, $50, $60 million. All right. Somebody says, damn, Coach lived in Newport. Yep. I know if you just found me 2 years ago, within the last 2 years, I just moved to Vegas. He says, where are white women? On the coast. There's some white women in the inland too, but they're probably on meth. Or fat. Or a pog. All right. The fit white women are on the coast. All right, so if you want some flatback Supremes, they're on the coastline. All right, right down here, all the way here, where you see where the water is and you see the towns on the coast, Malibu, Huntington Beach, somewhat Long Beach, Newport Beach, Laguna, Dana Point, San Clemente, I'll skip Oceanside, Carlsbad, Encinitas, Del Mar, all right, La Jolla, San Diego, that's where all the flatbacks are. And there's no ninjas out there either. There's no ninjas. All right, shout out to our brother DW says, I know how Fresh probably feels. I too have gone too far with the neighborhood tramp and became embarrassed about it and backed out. He says, these are usually sweet girls, just promiscuous. Promiscuous. Indeed. Fixes of Mind says, I hope your goofy friend made himself some money. He made himself some money? All right. I'm trying to figure out what happened there. Where the Latinas at? All over Southern California. Latinas are everywhere, but they tend to not be completely on the coastline. All right. Latinas run Southern California, just so you know. If you like Latinas, you can plop yourself on anywhere in this map and you're going to find them within a 10-minute drive. Okay, this place is hovering by Latinas. All right, yep. Latinas everywhere in the whole map. Now, if you want your best chance, I would go to like Corona. I would go to Santa Ana. If you know Santa Ana, the Virgin Mary Mother, Santa Ana. I would go to Oceanside. Lots of Latinas there. That's near in between Southern California. Orange County and San Diego. Anywhere in the San Fernando Valley, which you're going to find Latinas everywhere. Ninja, they everywhere, bro. You will never have not enough Latinas. East Los Angeles, East Los. The coastline typically doesn't have a lot. If they are, they're a little bit more refined. There ain't no, like, you know. But they're all over this place. All over it. You could have gorditas all day long. Yeah, Downey, San Gabriel Valley, Pomona. I mean, you'll never gonna run out of Latinas in Southern California. They everywhere. He says, I love Latina women. Now remember, these are okay. You guys gotta know about California Latinas are different than worldwide Latinas, Ninja. They a little bit different. All right. Yo. Where the thick Samoans at? Bell Gardens. They in Bell Gardens, Hawthorne, Inglewood, Cerritos is where the Asians are. All right, Cerritos are where the Asians are. All right, so anyway, by the way, Southern California is very segregated racially as well. They definitely have places. You want Armenians, you want Burbank or Glendale. Burbank, Glendale, you're going to have Armenians. All right, that's Armenians are the Kardashians, essentially. But they're not going to all look like Kardashians. They're going to be kind of very energetic. But they're going to have fat booties, real ones, too. So Burbank, Glendale, Armenians. San Fernando Valley, Encino, you got.
I'm not going to say what race, what people. We know I can't say that.
Oxnard, Mexicans, poor blacks. Thousand Oaks, white folks. Agoura Hills, that's Calabasas. Gorg Hills, that's where I went to high school. White folks. All right, that's generally going to be where it is. Hawthorne, Inglewood, Torrance, mostly blacks and Latinos. White folks down in Huntington Beach, Newport Beach, Laguna, Dana Point, San Clemente, white folks. Santa Ana, Latinos. All right, Anaheim, it's a mix. Poor whites or lower economic whites, Latinos, very few blacks. By the way, blacks make up 10% of the 23 million, less than 10%. Pasadena, old money. La Cunada, Flint Ridge, old money. That's old Hollywood money. That's old money. That's old white folks money up in there. Santa Clarita is a mix. You're going to get a mix up in there. It's going to be very diverse. Palmdale, lots of poor people there. Mostly poor people that living kind of rich. Corona, Riverside, mostly like working class whites, Latinos. A few blacks. Moreno Valley, blacks, Latinos. Oceanside, most military family, military family extended. So you have military whites, military Samoans, military Mexicans. They're kind of like military oriented. Irvine, Asians, Irvine, Garden Grove, Westminster. All right, that's where the Asians are. Cerritos, Asians, Los Alamitos, Asian, white, working class, so forth and so on. This is just in general. San Bernardino, poor whites. Meth heads, poor whites. San Bernardino. Let's see here. Yep, that's pretty much it there. I lived in Southern California for 30 years. Thousand Oaks, yeah. Ventura, kind of like, I guess, a valley people that were rich in the 80s and 90s. Coronado. Yeah, Coronado, rich people. Rich people. Coronado and near San Diego. Santee, working class whites there. And a few, like, Samoans, Latinos there. All right. Anyway, I know this place like the back of my hand. Like the back of my hand. Koreatown. Oh, yeah, Koreatown, too. Bellflower is mostly going to be, like, Latinos, Samoans, a few kind of very working class. Like just working class and below. Yeah, brother. I know this map like the palm of my hand. Palm Springs, Reading Rainbow, vacation homes.
I'm not going to say what race, what people. We know I can't say that.
But then Palm Desert is poor whites or working class whites. All right, but you got a lot of Reading Rainbow out in Palm Springs and a lot of people that own vacation homes in the desert. They call that the desert. We got a home in the desert, Palm Springs. You don't want to go there in July. You don't want to go there in July. Pasadena is a mix, but it's mostly old money. But there is a section near Pasadena called Monrovia, very close to that. Pasadena also has John Muir High School, which is overwhelmingly athletic black. So they have a poverty drop there. But if you go into Pasadena in the hills, this is where old money is. All right. So the house in, I think, Back to the Future, a lot of movies, the houses were in Pasadena. This is where old Hollywood celebrities used to go. And the rich people that ran Los Angeles, they used to live out in Pasadena. So you will see big old mansions in Pasadena. Not like McMansions now. And these are like old big estates. Like from the old school, they'll look like this. They'll have like the, let me see here. They'll look like houses like this, like old mansions that were old mansions in back in the day. I think the house in Back to the Future, Doc Brown's house, I think was in Pasadena. I might be wrong. All right, but Pasadena's old money. Where are all the blacks? Los Angeles, Watts. They're all jammed into there. Watts, Southern Los Angeles, South Central. Like, then when you go out of there, blacks are sparse. They're very sparse. Like, people think there's a lot of black people that live in Southern California. And, guys, if you leave Watts, South Central. If you leave Inglewood and Hawthorne and Torrance or maybe Lawndale, when you leave there, there's not that many blacks. You leave there, there's not that many. Like, when you go to a school outside of those areas, outside of Crenshaw, which is a district, it's not really a city. Once you leave that and you go out and you leave Baldwin Hills and you're out there, you're liable to be the only black person in your class. Right? So they in the hood, in the ghetto. They're all crammed into one spot. And I ain't even joking. Compton, even there, they're all, most of the blacks in Southern California jammed into one spot. Now, they do have Palmdale and Moreno Valley where they got chased out to in the 80s and 90s. They got ran out there to get cheap houses. But they're all crammed into one spot. Once you leave that spot, you're liable to not see that many blacks comparatively to the people you've seen. And this is no joke. Like, compared to, like, you'll see some, but compared that to the amount of people you see, you'll see 5 Mexicans and 4 white people and an Asian before you see another black. And I ain't even lying. And you multiply that by hundreds and thousands of people in a day, you will realize the black population is very small. Anyway, he said the jungle is wild as hell. All right, shout out to Southern California. Oh, guys, man, if you want to live in Southern California, please do not move there if you don't have no hustle. They don't need no more slaves out there. Please go out there and hustle. It's a hustle culture, and it's a scammer culture. All right, shout out to Half Space Will Travel says, after that video, no more Lily Lit Licking or Cunnilingus. Appreciate you. Yeah, all of Cali is like that. All of Cali is like that for sure. So don't think that they're everywhere. Now, numerically wise, there's a lot. And once you leave Southern California going into Northern California, it's wild. What do we got here? Maryland guy says, one of my dad's friend's son knows this girl in high school that has 80K TikTok followers. Absolutely crazy. Average guys stand no chance. Yep. You will see that too, man. You will see that. Guys, that's a reality for a lot of men. What happened? Looks like your chat went away, sir. Oh, there it is. Yeah, if a young woman has a lot of TikTok followers or Instagram, it's kind of tough. Shout out to Maryland guy says, I know someone that lives in Fresno. I was surprised when he told me most of California is actually red, but it's the coastal areas that mess it up. Yeah, it's really Los Angeles and San Francisco that mess up the liberal. The rest of the areas in California are very Republican and somewhat conservative. But it's San Francisco and Los Angeles. Now, the problem is you're talking about 40 million people in San Francisco and LA. It's really they're jammed in. The liberals are jammed into one spot. And they vote for everything against the general populace. But this is another thing. If you know anything about California politics, it's not rigged. I'm not saying it's rigged, but it's definitely owned. All right. Just so you guys know, there ain't no getting around it. They called it the California Mafia for a reason. All right. I got super chats. We're going to get through them, man. We got you, man. Thank you for the contributions. What are we doing? We got our brother. Where the doo-doo is, says a big booty and wide hips ain't for baby delivery. It's for my face. Come on, coach. Get it together. All right. Nasty boys in here.
Oh, that's nasty.
All right. It says right here, Cambino says, coach is telling the truth. I got that one already. Schedule P, shout out to you. He says, coach, I keep winning in my life, and the higher I ascend, the more I look back on those who doubted me. It's a shame I had to leave them behind when they could have enjoyed the ride with me. He says, watching their descent can be sad, but it is what it is. Free agent lifestyle for life. You can't help them all, Ninja. You can't help them all. Can't help them all. Shout out to Dennis B. says Lawrence Fishburne is. I'm skipping some. JC says my crotch hurts. Okay, I got that. But the International Quiet Storm says Jonathan Majors was about to use this soft guy era for a major comeback. Drizzle, drizzle. All right. Derek Choi says Kevin Durant definitely calls his mama, his mother, mama. All right. He calls his mother, mama. He does, mama. Shout out to Marcel H says, sounds like a chat GPT list. AI is powerful. Could be. Khalid says, paying my dues to the GOAT, CGA. He says, shout out to my pops, AK, who is also gaining this knowledge from you, coach. God bless you, brother. Thank you, sir. Janissary happening in Las Vegas now. Divorce court, Dennis Prince and a woman in his 30s in his office were deleted before the gunman took his own life. Wow, man. Guys. I don't get it, man. Y'all got to remove this emotion, man. Shout out to you right here, the Renaissance man. That's terrible. I'm going to look that story up. Enigma WPG says, coach, we got the same taste in Video Vixen, but we are close in age. He says, can you do a hit it or quit it on that girl? He says, damn, she was fine back in the day. Somebody's got to give me her name. Anthony Allen says, coach, I just paid off my truck. And I bought myself a California King bed, living life to the fullest, free agent lifestyle. He says, forever. Thank you. Shout out to you, brother. Congratulations on the California King. You living like a king, man. Once I got my first California King, I said, I ain't never going back to a king or a queen. Well, it's kind of like a king anyway. I think we got everything. UConn up 9 points, as I told you. They're going to win. Shout out to Lamont James says, a Rolls Royce in Tupelo. Wow. A Rolls Royce in Southern California equals a normal car. These cars are sometimes a $500,000. And he says, you got $3.85 in your pocket. I think that's a good situation where we can tell men that's Southern California versus other women around the world. In Southern Cal, you get quite accustomed to nice luxury vehicles. Now, not every place in Southern California, you're going to see nice luxury vehicles. But you're more likely to see BMWs just about anywhere in Southern California. Anywhere. Like BMW is a normal car. Now, the closer you get to the coast and up in the hills, a BMW is a 16-year-old girl's car. A 3 Series BMW will belong to a 16, 17, 18-year-old. Certainly around Malibu, Thousand Oaks, you know, you're liable to see that. Orange County, Newport Beach. That's an entry-level car for them. And every guy that thinks they're balling going to be BMW 5 Series. You know, most people spend most of their money on cars. Especially if they're trying to impress and be in the scene. If you get to a point where you're monk mode or you're something like that in this area, well, you gotta ignore a lot of people. But you won't fall into the trap of having a $1,500 car payment for no reason at all. But a G-Wagon, a Lamborghini, a McLaren, you're going to see this all over Southern California, especially along the coast. It's easy. Like, I mean, I show videos where I've done vlogs. This is easy. In fact, a Porsche 911 is not a standout car in Orange County, especially if you're talking about Newport Beach, Corona Del Mar, Huntington Beach, Laguna, Dana Point. A 911 Porsche is not a standout car. It is a nice car, by the way. It's a nice car. It ain't a bad car. But a Porsche 911 will stand out in Las Vegas, especially if it's nice. It'll stand out in Las Vegas. In Southern California, Orange County, it won't. Why? Because you're normally seeing Maybachs, Rolls Royces, Double R. You're seeing Bentley Continental S's. You're seeing cars that are worth $250,000, $350,000. $400,000, $500,000, $500,000, $500,000. Okay, easily. You're seeing Bugattis in Newport Coast. Yeah, Miami similar. Miami is like that as well, where a Porsche 911 won't stand out like that. You would need like a GT, something like that, a turbo. You will need some crazy shit. Even then, all right, even then, it doesn't really stand out because it's small, it's compact. It's a good car. But you're going to see high-end cars. You're going to see Barabbas G-Wagons. Not a regular G-Wagon. Not a G550 G-Wagon. Not a G63 G-Wagon. You're going to see Barabbas. You're going to see big-ass fucking G-Wagons. like G-Wagons that are $350K. You're going to see some crazy shit like, wow. Yeah, you need a GT3 RS. If you just got a Carrera S or a Carrera, eh. But you're not going to see that everywhere in Southern California. But yeah, that's kind of how Southern California is right there. That's kind of how Southern California is. It's a mess. So the car hypergamy is a thing. And the reality of it is you need a car in Southern California. All right. You need a car in Southern California. You cannot live in Southern California without a car. You can, but it's going to be tough. It's going to be freaking tough to live in Southern California with no car. You don't even understand. You see all these blue lines? Those are freeways, and they're all different. They're all different. You cannot get from one place and the other side of Los Angeles to the other, and you're going to need to. So you're really on the struggle bus if you don't have a car in Southern California. Like, you're limited on where you can go. So you need a car. If you don't have a car, you're kind of fucked. I can't even imagine. Like, in other areas, you can go without a car. You can live without a car in Miami and get around fine. Right? And get around fine. But you need a whip. You need a whip. And you need, like, you don't need a car in New York. You could be one of these guys. You don't need a car in New York. In California, you need a car. You getting nowhere. You fuck. And don't think you getting no pussy out there. You're not getting any sex. And don't depend on the bus. If you think you're going to ride the bus and get around Southern California, you're out of your lunatic mind. Because some places, especially high-end areas, they don't have a bus. Newport Beach, there's one bus, and that takes you right down the Pacific Coast. They don't be taking you in and up the hill and by the mansions. They don't go up there. And that's for a reason. They don't want those buses up there. So you got to go get dropped off in the bus terminal and walk where you need to go. And that shit going to take you an hour to get home. So, yeah, it's a thing there. So a lot of guys will tell you on the internet, they grew up on the East Coast or New York, and they be like, man, y'all don't need a car. Don't spend your money on a car. Guys, that applies in New York City. In Southern California, you need a car. And if you actually tour Los Angeles and you did not have a rental car, you saw nothing. I hear this all the time. Man, I went to L.A. and they stayed in downtown L.A. You know how many people I hear this from? They stayed in downtown in L.A. and they did not have a rental car and they went to L.A. I'm like, you didn't see shit. He said they use Uber. Yeah, Uber is, it's tough to get an Uber around here. These Ubers going to cost you $200 to get from one place to the next. So you didn't see shit if you went to L.A. and you walked around downtown. It is not the same as New York downtown. All right. L.A. is nobody goes downtown. All right. Except for people who live in downtown L.A. If you did not have a rental car, you saw nothing. But that's what it is right there. Yeah. Downtown. I barely ever go to downtown in Los Angeles. I try to avoid it as much as I can. Only thing downtown is the Staples Center or whatever they call it, Crypto Arena, where the Lakers and the Clippers play, although the Clippers are moving. That's downtown. And they have that's about it. All right. They got some nice restaurants, hole in the wall. But if you don't know where you're going, I would not. No, there's no way. There's no way. Anyway. Yeah. So a lot of guys thinking that, oh, man, you don't need no car. And it's in California, Southern California, your car is everything. Your car is everything, unfortunately. Like, you ain't getting, you're not pulling, listen, guys are going to tell me, you're not pulling baddies with no car. And if you got a basic car, you can fucking forget it. Unfortunately, guys, I know people are going to be like, nah, man, you don't need, I can run mouthpiece. In California, mouthpiece ain't it, right? I hate to tell you, that mouthpiece shit is not it in Southern California. Now, if you're somewhere in the mix, yes. But there's plenty of places in the mix. There's a scale of have. And if you ain't shit, you ain't going to be in the right spot. But if your car is everything in Southern California. Whatever that car is, if it stands out, you're going to have a better chance. If you got a basic car, you're going to have to put in some work. If you ain't got no car, forget it. You're going to be banging straggle daggles. Right? He says, you are getting no females in Southern California without a nice car. 100%. It's all materialism. You're in Marina Del Rey trying to pull baddies and you ain't got no whip or your whip is whack. Fuck it. You out. You out. Look at all these guys in California. They'll tell you, you out the game, Ninja, with no nice car. You out the damn game. He says, I had a Benz and it was no good. Yep. A Mercedes. C-Class. A C-Class Mercedes. You was out. You can't talk to nobody. Right? Boy, and people think, man, no, man, it's different. Coach, you just don't know. Brothers, let me just tell you. You on Ventura Boulevard with a fucked up whip, you out the game. Right. Because every nice spot has valet. You can't just park anywhere in Southern California in most places. You got to valet your shit. So you pull up. You pull up. Your valet game got to be on point. Your valet game is on point. You can talk. Your valet game ain't on point. Yeah, Benz is average. A Mercedes-Benz is average. Every basic bitch got a Mercedes-Benz C-Class in Southern California. Like all these Instagram models and TikTok, a Mercedes-Benz C-Class is basic in Southern California. I'm talking about in the nice areas. And I'm not talking about in Monrovia. I'm not talking about in Monrovia. So let me show you what a C-Class is. This car right here. Basic. That's basic right there, Ninja. You might as well got a Toyota Camry. Everybody know what that is. That's a C-Class. You ain't getting shit out here with that. You're going to think you're doing something. Now, if you in Watts, South Central, Inglewood, you're going to try to get carjacked. You asking for it. Right? All right. You asking for it. But this right here, you out the game. AMG. Now, if you got an AMG, you done stepped it up. And he says applies to all California. Yep. That's the car game is everything in the West Coast on California. Your car game got to be on point. Sadly enough, I know people are going to say, no, man, I made it out there without it. So your Mercedes is going to look like this. You're going to have to get this. This is the AMG right here. This is how your shit going to have to look. If you in the Mercedes game and you want to be like, oh, the woman says he drives a Mercedes, you got to have to be like this. It's got to have to be an AMG right here, C63. This is a C-Class, but it's an AMG C63. All right, BMW 3 Series, you out of there. Every college girl at USC and UCLA, not every, but the hot ones got access to a 3 Series. All right, so the girls at the top that you want to get to when you're trying to impress, a BMW 3 Series, fuck that. Right? You're going to need a 5 Series at least. You're going to need a 5 Series, fam. This is just overtime, by the way. We just messing around. You're going to need a 5 Series. Yep, 5 or 7 Series. Yep, or an E-Class Mercedes. You're going to need that. That's where a game is over there. And or if you want to get the Cholas, you can get you a low rider. You can get you a little low rider. And that'll keep you in. Dodges and Challengers are not really a big thing on the West Coast. I mean, it's there. You can do well there. You can do well. But they're not as big as they are, say, in Las Vegas. Challenger and all of that Hellcat is big. Definitely when I go to the South or like Houston, Hellcat seem to be way bigger there. Southern California Hellcat is not that big of a deal in the dating game. It's not that big. It's not that like the wow factor. It's not because we just don't have like the strags. You're not trying to impress the strags. So it typically is a straggle impressive car. That's a hood car. And when you're in Southern California, the hoods are where you want to avoid. You never want to go up in that motherfucker. Like, dudes that operate and run game in the hood, have at it. Most guys try to avoid the hood. So you're not trying to get hood broads in Southern California because they're not the peak. They're not the best of the best. They're always they're dangerous. So, yeah, you're looking at somebody said Range Rover. It's always a safe bet as well. Range Rover. Yeah. But you're not trying to get Strags in SoCal. Strags going to be Inglewood, Hawthorne. Like when I used to match with people in Inglewood, Hawthorne, Gardena, Southgate, Downey. Yep. Yeah. So you trying to get bougie chicks. Yeah. Corvette. I would put Corvette certainly under the 911. Corvette really is not a big car in Southern California. Now, you do have Corvette clubs. But a Corvette to pull a woman? No. A Corvette to be standing out like I got a Corvette? No. Now, I'm just saying that it's not a shitty car. I'm saying it's not a standout vehicle at all. Corvette, no. You'd be better off trying to get an AMG, a C63. Like, that's, you stand out. But Corvette ain't going to be a panty dropper. It ain't going to be, you're going to get a lot of old broads in their 50s and 60s in a Corvette. It's still a good car, but you're not going to get no standout. You're going to get like an old broad. It's a really a middle car, still a nice car, but it's like an old white man's car in California. Even a Porsche is an old white man's car. A Porsche is like, he has a Porsche. That's like a car for a man in his 50s, 60s. Yeah. That's kind of how it's viewed. It's okay. It ain't bad, but it ain't that good. Rolls Royce. Let me show you the big baller car. And Southern California is more like a kind of people want to look upscale. They don't want to look like. This is we're talking about the upscale areas. This is when you know somebody's somewhat balling if they driving this. Let me see here. You see them driving this? That's when you know they got a high lease payment. Right here. That's the Malibu, Newport Coast, La Jolla near San Diego. When they driving this right here, you see this shit right here, or anything in the Bentley, Rolls Royce category, that's when you know. All right, they got some shit like this. This car right there, that's a $225,000 car. And if it's convertible, you really know. That's the big baller car when it's convertible. And so you'll see like Middle Eastern guys, young guy, like this is an ageless car. Yeah, Maserati ain't going to do it, guys. Maserati is out. Maserati is not a baller car in California. If he got this, this the one right here. This the one right here. He said Bentley played out. Bentley's played out. Yeah. SoCal, that's the car right there. That's the big baller car type of deal. Where you're kind of older, mature. Maserati seems like a toy. It's a toy. Audis are decent. Audis are kind of decent. They're decent. R8 type of deal. It's up there. You'll be all right. All right. Yeah, but you can't win. Your car game is everything. And if you have no car, you get Aston Martin. Aston Martin does well. You look kind of upscale, you know, James Bond. Yeah, Aston Martin does well. These are in the higher influence areas. Classic cars, you're not with the young girls. With the older women, classic cars will do it. So if you have a classic car, it'll do it. Younger girls, no. Trucks, I'm going to tell you what two trucks you need in the truck category. What two trucks? And these are not like pickup trucks. All right, pickup trucks are not really that big in SoCal, although there's an area where you could do well with pickup trucks. But I'm going to tell you what two truckish type cars you need. Southern California, you're going to crush it. You need a Jeep Wrangler. You're going to crush it, especially with younger women in flatbacks. And or the Ford Bronco. The new Ford Bronco. You're going to crush it in SoCal. And G-Wagon. Ford Raptor, too. Ford Raptor. You need the Ford Raptor. Okay, the Lamborghini Urus. F-350 lifted. Jeep Wrangler. Ford Bronco, the new one. The Ford Bronco, the new one. Yep, and the lifted Raptor. Ford Raptor. Yep, those are the ones. You need a Raptor. You can't just have an F-150. If you do, you'll get a little bit. F-150, but you need the F-350. You need the big one. Cybertruck, kind of, I don't know. I haven't been there since the Cybertruck came out. F-350 lifted. Yeah, that mother sucker going to stand out. Yeah, you're going to need an F-350 up in this mug. All right, so yeah, you're going to need this right here, SoCal. You're going to need a big old road eater right there. You're going to need the big one right there. You're going to need the big one. Don't get the 150, bro. Yeah, the Rolls-Royce Cullinan. These are out of reach for sure, but the Rolls-Royce Cullinan. Let me see. The new Ford Bronco is crazy. But if you go down to the beach towns or you go down to areas and you got the Ford Bronco, the new one, you're going to be good right there. Right there. But then once you go into the inner cities are slightly different. You could go in there with anything. But just so you know, if you go, he said the 2500 Denali, yeah, you're going to need that. You don't need the big one with big wheels on it. You're going to need all of that. If you go in the hood, this is what I'm going to tell you. The hood does not have good parking. So whatever car you take to the hood is going to stand out. Then when you park it, normally who you're visiting in these bungalows and shit like this, in these multifamily unit houses and apartments, whoever you're visiting, you're not parking in the front of that house or apartment. You're parking down the fucking street or around the corner. Which means you can't keep an eye on your car. Just know, if that car stands out, you're risking a lot. So whatever woman you're clapping cheeks, that car, like I could not park the 911 in some places in Long Beach. Like I would not drive that car. I would switch to the BMW, the older BMW. That shit going to be scratched up, keyed up, smashed up, windowed up. It's going to be on bricks. Ninja, you don't want to do that. You can't drive your Denali up there because of space. Don't drive your shit up there with the booming. That shit going to be gone. Your Dodge Challenger Charger is certainly going to be gone. It's going to be gonzo. They're going to steal it. They're going to steal that Charger if it's not in front of the fucking house. They're stealing it. So don't think that if you come into these areas with these nice cars and you can just pull up and park it somewhere. Nah. And Long, it might get towed. It might get towed. When I was in Long Beach, I had my car towed because the parking's so sparse that normally wherever you're parking, it has a fucked up sign. Long Beach has signs with like five parking. Let me see here. Messed up parking signs. I got my car towed in Long Beach. So Long Beach has it. So when you pull up to the, yeah, it'll be like this. This is how it'll be. It'll be like New York. This is what the sign will look like when you park in Long Beach on the street. This is what you pull up to right here. And you're trying to figure out if you can park there overnight to clap some girl's cheeks. And then you think you're going to come out at 2 a.m. and your car going to be there. And then you're going to fuck around and find out. It's going to be permitted parking, resident only. You got to move that car Tuesday morning at 2 in the morning or that shit getting towed. Yep. That's how the shit looks and you park in Long Beach. And you're like, can I park here? I'm not sure. And you just chance it. Some places in SoCal, that's what the parking shit looks like. And then you need a permit. You're like, oh, man, okay, I'm going to leave it here. And you go upstairs, you clap cheeks, you come back down 2 in the morning, car gone. Towed. And now you got to find out which tow company. Huntington Beach, yep, same thing. And you went to just go, you drove 2 hours to clap some cheeks in traffic. And then left at 2 a.m., car gone. Or it'll say you need a residential sticker. And with all these signs like this, car gone for some pussy. All right. Then you'd be like, damn, all for some ass. Then you got to go get cash, go to the tow truck stop. You got to have $500, $600. Don't have no parking tickets. Don't have none of that. This could be $1,000 night. Could be $1,000 night. If your car get towed. All right. Whack. And shout out to UConn, definitely pulling out the dub here, going up 20 just about. But look, man, enough of this messing around. Let me check Super Chat. Shout out to our brother. Blue Sox says, just got back from San Luis Obispo. Shout out to Slow. He says they don't have any restaurants with drive-thrus, Walmarts, or ninjas out there. They don't. San Luis Obispo is on the coast. They don't mess around. They literally keep poor people out strategically by, you know what, good thing, let me say this. The way to keep poor people out of your community is not having fast food restaurants that are easily accessible. Like, if you, when I lived in Newport Beach in Corona Del Mar, to go to McDonald's was an event. It was like, oh, shit. And the one McDonald's they had was on a PCH, and it was trafficky. It was tight. You couldn't get in and out of that motherfucker. It was, so what I found out was there's not a lot of fast food restaurants. And this is a high upscale area. There's not a lot of fast food restaurants. In order for you to get food, you have to go in and go to a place and pay, or a strip mall or the mall. But that's how they keep poor people out. They limit the bus line so that people aren't coming from poor areas to wealthy areas. They limit the amount of fast food restaurants. Okay, so there's not a lot of fast food restaurants. And they keep the rents high. That's how you keep poor people out. No Popeyes. Yep, guys. I pulled up the map of Popeyes. Pull up the map of Popeyes. It's only in middle class poor areas. They don't have them in wealthy areas. No Popeyes. Right? Yep. No Church's Chicken, no Popeyes, no nothing. They literally, that's how they keep you out. All right, same thing in the coastal area. Santa Barbara, you're not going to find just restaurants and fast food restaurant chains. They're there, but they're not just going to be everywhere. San Luis Obispo's like that. Santa Barbara's like that. Thousand Oaks is like that. Newport Beach, all of these areas like that. Malibu, I don't even think there's any fast food in Malibu. Yep, no Greyhound, nothing. That's how they keep you out of there, because you're less likely to be you. You got to go get some kale or some shit like that. No liquor stores. No churches, no wig stores. They like, we ain't letting none of that shit in there. Yep, no gun stores, none of that. That's how they keep you up out of there, bro. And they keep the bus line. You can't take the buses. That bus stops right there, and it turns back and goes to Santa Monica. No pawn shops, nothing. That's how they keep you out. That's how they keep your ass out of there. But anyway, he said no Mexican restaurants. Okay. All right, I'm done with y'all ninjas, man. Look, shout out to the Coach Gang. Man, thanks for hanging out. I think I got everybody. I just want to clear the deck before we go. Yep, we got everybody on there. Let me stay logged in. I'm just checking it up over here. He said no wig stores, no nothing. It's just Whole Foods and shit. You ain't lying, bro. That's how they keep you up out of there. All right, brothers, enjoy. Shout out to the Coach Gang. We'll be back for Tuesday. Peace.
Look what she did to my car. What the bitch did to my car? I can't stand it, though. I can't stand this bitch. Fuck this bitch.
It's barbecue in there.